Hey, welcome. We are here just in time. I think you might have caught the end of another successful Malware Bytes patrol against malware on my gaming rig. So congrats to me. Patrick, are you here ready to go shopping?
Rob, you gave me... All right, so sometimes Kato gives us a countdown that disappears, and then we don't know where the time is. And it's like 10, 9, and then I sat down, casually got myself some water, got myself some coffee, literally like settled in to say, hey, Rob, like whenever you're ready, he's like, yeah, 3, 2, and then you just like launched me like a fucking rocket into the street.
The thing you couldn't hear was that the song was trailing off to like, it was hitting its natural end.
You could have told me, like you were channeling.
I did tell you, 3, 2, 1, go. That's about how long we had before it looped.
That is not you. Nothing about a song was ever said. But I don't know what you want to tell yourself.
It was unfortunate timing. That's for sure. So the intent here, Patrick, was we'll get into why I'm doing cabinet shopping here in a second. But I went to Google, and Google suggests things that you might want to know about.
Well, and you're not signed in. Are in. I'm sure there is still tracking.
Yes.
Occurring. What it is it able to claw cookies from your other accounts? Like, I don't know, but I was charmed and interested when you loaded this up and I said, stop. I do want to know what the Costco Bud Light beer thing is, but I want you to click it.
Well, that's definitely going to be about transphobes. 100%.
Is it? Well, probably, yeah. But why is Costco involved?
That's a great question. Maybe Costco.
I know it is probably a transphobic thing, but am I... Does Costco do a bad?
Well, I think it will depend on who you ask, but let's see what's going on with...
Costco sends a quiet but powerful message on Bud Light.
Okay, what's the...
Is Costco set to drop Bud Light?
There's an entire content farm now around this fucking...
What's the street? Who is the street? They have crypto at the top. This is clearly right wing.
Yeah, almost certainly. So yeah, this is going to be, so this is, there's an entire ecosystem trying to keep the Dylan Mulvaney thing alive.
Yes.
And keep like stoking outrage about it. And so this is like, this appears to be a bunch of stories about almost nothing. Okay.
Like maybe because they don't have
maybe they did do a bad here. What is this here?
This is the Gazette. That sounds more legitimate.
It does, but you know, you can never tell about these things.
Washington Examiner. That is a right-wing publication. That is just there. The Gazette is just aggregating.
So this is people. Yeah, this is people like grabbing stuff. So that appears to be what this bullshit is. So that's like, and my Pixel phone, every time I scan over to like what is trending news, it's just this shit nonstop. Okay, now, okay, this is weird.
All right, we've
just
moved.
From having done that,
yeah,
all of this has changed. It still thinks I want to know about the cheeseburger made of cheese. But now it's like, maybe you want to know about John Gruden, Dan. Hey, you seem like someone who's interested in bigotry.
What's?
Do you want to know more about John
no!
Gruden and Dan Snyder?
Oh, no!
Yeah,
is
dude. So
happened?
I had pure innocent Google suggested searches now, and now it's like, you want to get your 2-minute hate on? Hey, who am I kidding? What about your like 2-day hate?
Well, I believe there was a big report that came out from ESPN or somebody that was essentially the reason Dan Snyder is going down is because of the John Gruden. Like there's a direct line between.
Well, that was always like, I think from the moment that came out, it was so clear that something was up with like the way that entire thing got leaked. Mm-hmm. And so there was always like a weird element of like to get to Dan Snyder, they had to go through John Gruden is almost how it played out. Like that like the leaks had to come out. But we will set that aside.
Dalvin Cook to the Miami Dolphins. Oh, wow. Okay. All right. Yeah.
That makes sense.
Yeah. Free agent. No, wait. Oh. See, look at this.
It's not real.
Are the Miami Dolphins
it's not real.
The right fit for Dalvin Cook who wants a bit?
One Jets insider. Jets insider. No. No. I'm
Come
sorry,
on.
My friend. I'm sorry.
Come on. This is. is garbage. I mean, I know that. I've never really related to Reese's. Well, so we are often talking about the Miami Heat. Now we've just become Dolphins fans.
Well, I think we've not changed. We've simply been more closely dialed in on. It's Rob, like, oh, you're probably a Miami expat. Mm-hmm. You're a right wing bigot. We got millions of you.
Rob, what did the Miami Dolphins do?
Well, isn't their owner Mr. SoulCycle Shithead?
I don't know if that's true. I mean, I know they lost that first round draft pick because of the Tom Brady tampering a couple years back, but I just like, what did the Miami Dolphins do?
No, that's Stephen Ross.
Yeah, I just don't know that's the SoulCycle. I just don't know that. I believe you. Cycling accidents.
Centers. Because I think he like owns a
Planet Fitness.
Ooh. Oh, that company fucking sucks. And yes, they're terrible. Were SoulCycle too. Yeah, fuck these people. Planet Fitness is just one of the worst places possible. Okay, so.
Yeah.
Cabinets.
Mm-hmm.
All right, so here's the
love them, love to hate them.
So you might be wondering, we'll talk about this probably more at length down the road, but you know, I'm sure you've also been in the same boat where it's like, it's nice to think about, maybe we could have a nicer home and a bigger home someday. And then you go like looking at listings and it's just bad. It's like, it's no good time to buy a house.
I saw recently that the like 7% mortgage is like here to stay. That is just the new standard. Like this world that I bought a house in where we bought it at 4 or 5% and then refinance to get into something in 3%. Like that, I pretty much can't give up my house.
Yes.
Purely based on that. With like the dream house could open down the street, but I'd be buying it at bare minimum 7%, which to be fair is what all of our parents did. Like one of the reasons we're in the crisis that we're in is because there's a housing shortage combined with being able to afford houses extremely cheaply, which people should be able to buy houses, but 2% mortgages are a fever dream.
Right. And then you're doing the whole like mortgage calculator thing and you realize like, wow, I could save for like 5 years and I would still just get crushed under the mortgage, mm-hmm. even with a sizable down payment. And so my response to that was I was, you know, going on Zillow as one is wont to do, be like, hey, like what seems achievable here? Ooh. And apparently the things I started surfacing from my Zillow dives with and sort of offering up were becoming concerning. And MK was like, hey, are these the sorts of homes you're going to be suggesting we go look at if we don't like make this house a little nicer? And mm-hmm. I was like, what do you mean? This home looks great. It comes with a Corvette in the garage. It says mm-hmm, Corvette mm-hmm. comes with the house. Mm-hmm. And she was like, yeah, baby, that's because someone clearly died here recently. Mm-hmm. And it appears like that they were in ill health for a long time. That home looks like it hasn't been maintained in like 20 years. And
I'd
also
take the Corvette though. I mean, like if it's just there, it was
under a sheet and it was a 1960s Stingray Corvette, which can be cool when they're like maintained, but I had strong suspicions. Maybe it wasn't.
Cause I got a projector with my home that just came with the house. So you want that?
Yeah, so this is the type of stuff I'm saying. But then you get like you get caught not doing your due diligence where your wife is like, let's just scroll out and see why this home might be $300,000 below what the rest of homes like it are mm-hmm. asking for. Mm-hmm. And like, you know, this is MK, folks, just real detail oriented. Just clicks that mouse wheel back a few times and is like, oh, look at that. A toxic chemical quarry is down the hill from it. And maybe that is why people don't feel they can get a good price on this home.
I like that you're spending your time instead of what most people are doing, which is looking at houses they can't afford and just lamenting the fact that we have an artificial housing shortage by a bunch of people who won't let more affordable housing be built around them. And instead are just looking at what's in the garbage bin. You know, like maybe it's a diamond in the rough, just waiting for Rob Zacky to find it. Just a raccoon, just looking around like, well, that's, it may have been condemned last year, but not under this new ownership.
So, yeah, so I was I was starting to really rationalize some really sketchtastic homes, and it was becoming enough of a thing where, like, MK was like, I can't keep shooting down these homes. It's getting really tiring to say, like, no, that's not even worth looking at, and could you please look up anything about these addresses? But it did sort of highlight that we're probably, like, sensibly, we should be here for a little while longer. And we could be here quite a while longer if it were nicer, right? Like, part of the issue of, like, wanting to really get the hell out of here is that the kitchen cabinets are old as hell. They're incredibly cheap. They don't fit anything real well, like, with constant storage problems. Because basically they're just, like, big, they're big boxes with, like, no shelving inside it. So you just, like, toss shit in there and it doesn't store. And it's all been eaten through by mice anyway.
Which, is that still a problem? Where are we at? I feel like when I don't, maybe I shouldn't even say anything, because I feel like I'm invoking, like, channeling the mice into your home. But I haven't heard about them in a while.
It's entered a stable equilibrium, right? We are back to every 3 months you see a mouse, and then you don't see them for a while because you're like, oh, I better start cleaning up a little more diligently, you know, check out the poison traps again, and move on from it. So, like, it's entered a point, like, never going to be mouse free. That's just not in the cards in this building, but it's better. But the nice thing about, like, if we did a kitchen remodel and get into the walls, we could address the big problems with that, which is mainly the giant hole that runs through the utility chase the length of the building. So, cabinets.
Never looked at them. I have no frame of reference. So my wife and I are at a similar stage probably to you when we bought our home. People did tell us, like, do not buy a home that you cannot imagine being in for a very long time, under the premise that you'll find the forever home later. You don't know what your life's going to be like, what the economic forecast is going to be like.
Right.
And then crucially, we met neighbors that are best friends with our kids, and they live houses down from us. Like, actually both families had talked about, like, it'd be really nice if we had X, because all of our rooms are full between working at home and having kids. And so it's spacious. If I told you the space, like, you'd be like, that's a lot of space. And then you put people in it and then it fills up just like anything else. But between the locked in low mortgage rate, a stadium that might be built within running distance from here, and then having the like, kind of this one almost like familial ties down the street, it's like, we're here. So whatever issues you have with the house, how we can't build a basement. So that's the big one. That's out. Can't do that. I'm just stuck without a basement. But what else can we do? So we haven't gotten there yet, but we are in 6 months. My guess is I will be in a position that you're starting now.
So we'll start where we should always start, at the top, with just a nice modest little search for most luxurious kitchen cabinet brands.
Okay. Can you just click that first article? Because, like, there's so much bullshit that you get fed when you start looking this up. Give me today's homeowner. I want to know.
Is that even a good site? I've never heard of it.
No, I'm sure it's awful. Did a robot write this? This is definitely a prime candidate AI SEO garbage. But I want to see what they're telling me.
All right. High-end kitchen cabinet brands 101.
Oh, I mean, Danny, author Henry Parker.
That's a person's name. And
what is he? Who is he? Who is he? Can you give me?
Just an enthusiast.
He writes on a variety of topics. Henry lives in Florida with his wife and two kids and enjoys. I mean,
yeah, he's probably a real person.
That sounds real enough for me. Finding your brand. Okay.
All right.
Okay. Oh, is there a? I'm gonna look this up. I'm gonna see if there's a cabinet quiz.
Okay. Okay. So, high-end kitchen cabinets brands to watch: Starmark, Sioux Falls, South Dakota. They do high quality hardwoods, inviting, time worn look. You know what? I think I've had my fill of time-worn looks, to be honest. You know what?
You can get that naturally.
What about the opposite of that? What about brand spanking new? Looks like Tarkin just finished constructing it and is about to take it operational.
So this is primarily for the kitchen, right? This is where you're targeting this?
Yes.
Okay.
Sigma Factor, I'm going to spoil things for the chat. There's build-a-grade stuff for cheap apartments and house flips. Two expensive stuff that looks really good, and IKEA in the middle. No.
Okay, Rob, I have a...
We can do better than that.
I have a quiz for you. I'm going to send this to you.
Well, what Google search term is what I use to get to it?
You would use, what did I use to get here? Which kitchen cabinet are you quiz? And then you've got a variety of options, such as Lowe's, which we all know, or House.
Okay, which, yeah, now House I do know.
I gave you House. That's a real place? That's not House Magazine?
This is the quiz?
House, not House. How's, like, what's up? We're hanging out in the house. It's a little Arnold Schwarzenegger on it.
Okay. So, house quiz. What style of kitchen should you have? Should you be cooking up a storm in a modern, traditional farmhouse or another style of kitchen? Take our quiz to find out.
Rob about to get into cottage core.
Okay. What do you want most in your kitchen? A calm vibe. I love a calm vibe. Sunshine. Physically not possible.
Horizontal. Do you actually like a calm vibe? Is that true? Do you tell yourself that? I get a sense that maybe it's a little... Are you sure calm is the word that you're using?
Patrick, let me ask, do you think I'm someone who likes order?
Yeah, likes order.
Yes.
But and, is it order?
And order is calm.
Yeah, calm Rob. Yeah.
Horizontal lines. Fucking love horizontal lines. Oh, is that a vertical kitchen?
Here's the thing. I think you only get to pick one of these. So, you know, but it's most. What do you want most?
A sense of timelessness. I mean, I want it to last for fucking ever. If that's what you mean, I want to do this once and never touch it again until, like, we do move. Handmade tile. No, I'm good, my friend. I can do without that. Lots of texture. Sounds like a disaster.
Ooh, I want a good hand feel when I'm out there chopping up my onions.
An ocean breeze. I want an ocean front home to get the ocean front breeze? Yes. Lots of texture, simplicity, cutting edge appliances, stone, copper cookware, friends.
Well, I think they're saying there are ways to design
yes
kitchens that are socially minded, right? Yes. And you would have priorities that are different than it's like for cooking, and I want convenience of cooking. Above all else.
So I think for me, Patrick, what do you think is the answer for me here?
Well, we have to take off cutting edge appliances because that's going to happen regardless. Yeah. Right. Like that is just going to be, that is a defining feature. But I think what we're talking about here is more of the vibe of the kitchen. And so you say you want, do you want simplicity? Like, is it that you want the kitchen to be simpler?
I was lingering over simplicity because, like, I could see that being like, do I want it to be busy? No, I want it to be like clean and
right.
Like,
you want it to be effective, efficient. Yeah. So, simplicity of these options, yeah. I feel like, is the one that strikes me.
Yeah, this is what's speaking to me too. Like, we're gonna do simplicity. Mm-hmm. Okay. Pick a countertop material: natural quartz. Reclaimed wood, anything pure white.
Oh, what? Maybe is this a far right kitchen quiz?
No, people love the optic white, what do you call it? But like the bright white, like it looks like lab benches and such. People love.
Is this kind of like if we were to put this in technology terms, like how black are your blacks on a TV kind of situation?
Yeah.
Where there's black, and then there's OLEDs and stuff are able to display
true black. Yeah.
True black. Yeah. Okay.
Granite plus a stainless steel. Granite plus a stainless steel island. No. You have to choose, my friend. Calicata marble. I don't know. You got that sounds, me too. It sounds expensive. Sounds made up.
Yeah, it does sound calicata.
Bamboo. Bamboo does not sound expensive. Again with the handmade tiles. always with the handmade tiles.
Rob going into year three of his project is he makes the tiles. They're delightful, but he makes them one at a time.
I'm getting my next half dozen tiles next week. So we'll be able to get halfway across.
You can't walk across this area. Please be careful.
Natural limestone, butcher block, colored concrete, zinc?
Colored concrete? That seems like the texture must be gross. The texture must be different than what I'm thinking of that is on the street. My only familiarity with the concrete is...
Well, no, steps and... polished concrete is a thing. I assume that's what they're doing, but it would still be it would still have a cast of concrete color, I think.
You seal the concrete. So concrete is just the base, and then you're sort of putting something on top of it.
Okay, hang on. I just need a quick zinc countertops. Images. Oh, ooh, wait.
I don't know. I don't like the looks of these.
That looks a lot like... I would have said stainless steel.
Right. I think it looks like an uglier stainless steel.
Yeah, and also, in a lot of these, this hammered look is cool, but, that's fucking massive, man. I don't know.
This looks... this isn't the kind of stuff that I would see in an Airbnb, but I don't want it in my home.
Yeah. It kind of looks good with this, distressed old wood look, but that ain't me. And again, bet you it's expensive.
I bet it's expensive too.
Laminate comes in all kinds of grades. It's fine. Spanish gold marble, slate. I bet expensive.
Reclaimed wood seems like the kind of thing that would stain easily. And that's again, I'm speaking out of my ass here, but it strikes me that wood would look incredible, but the maintenance scares me.
Yeah. Yeah, that does scare me a bit as well. I'm kind of butcher block could be
a regular sponsor of Waypoint Radio.
Hey, if anyone from Butcher Box is watching and you wondered where we've gone,
dude,
to remapradio.com.
My wife asked me recently. She was like, "Hey, you're doing a new podcast.
Where's our box?"
She asked I think I'm going to buy a box. Do you think you're going to get sponsored again? I was like, I don't control that. I'm sorry. I think if you want the box, you got to buy the box. It is one of those rare times where the ad reads were genuine. We used a lot of the stuff in Butcher Box.
I mean, I think
Butcher Block is fancier wood or
Here's my question. When I think butcher block, that implies it's a work surface, that all of it would be work surface.
Mm-hmm.
But then you'd potentially have it scratched to shit, right? With like knives and stuff.
Well, it depends, right? It looks like a lot of the examples that I'm seeing here, some are using it for their kitchen counters. Some are using it for the island. The island is not a place where you're necessarily going to be doing a lot of your prep work. You're going to be doing a lot more of the serving and social aspect. And so it doesn't strike me as totally odd to have that part of it be potentially distinct. Now maybe everyone's matching it, and but it looks like the one in the upper left, right, has an island. I guess that's a rolling island, which is one that you can move around, which you'll need for smaller spaces. But I wonder if it makes sense on something like that, and then you would just have a different style on the rest of the kitchen. But that maybe makes less sense if you have a permanent island
I feel so. I do know that quartz is a really good alternative to granite. So granite has to be maintained, and I believe like the issue is if it's not sealed pretty well, if it's not like well maintained, it's porous. It's also like it's unlikely, but it is prone to shattering. I think quartz has a reputation
for being durable. Prone to shattering. Then Rob, I gotta be honest. We gotta get that. Take it off the list. I'm not sure we can trust you.
We'll do Butcher Block. Butcher Block it is.
I feel like Butcher Block is a good choice.
Yeah. Pick an accessory.
Ooh, ornate. Now this is Rob. I feel like here we go.
Ornate candlesticks.
My family.
I don't want friends coming over to my kitchen. I want my lover to join me.
Bamboo stalks? What does that mean? What does Google bamboo stalks? What does that even?
I think it's just gonna be shoots of bamboo as like.
What am I, a panda? Okay, yeah, I've seen these before. All right. Won't those go bad over time? The green ones.
I don't know. Bamboo's basically a weed. It's hardy. I don't know.
No, we don't.
I'm not feeling it either.
Bamboo is grass. It's just a thick grass. That's right. I've heard that before.
Handmade pottery. I'm not sure I have handmade pottery money after this kitchen remodel. I'm sorry.
It might be implied that maybe Rob is also going to the local community college and creating some handmade pottery.
A single bright flower in a simple vase. Fresh vegetables on the counter. But the problem is you have to remember to do something with them or they stop being fresh vegetables on the counter and they become compost.
Mm-hmm.
Antiques with a good amount of patina or patina.
What is that? What's patina?
Think about like the way copper discolors over time and takes on different colors and shades.
Antique look. I see.
Orchids, no orchid money here.
Also, just flowers in general.
Hey, look, we found my enemies. What about a funny little slogan?
There's like a big red button in the center. When you hit it, it makes a fart noise, Rob.
What about a little bass that you press a button on it? It sings at you. Sings goofy little songs.
What if there's like four different weapons here, and then you instruct your friends to let them know that we're going to fight each other outside? Pick your weapon.
Vintage vessels. I do love a tall ship. A new gadget.
I mean, didn't you show me at one point, or did you actually put this in your home? The like nautical light.
Yes, ship lights. Yes.
Did you do it?
Oh yeah, 100%. 100%. Like, okay. I have imported Italian like nautical fixtures in my house. A new gadget, heirloom tomatoes in a handcrafted bowl. Again, I point you to the the rate at which these things stop being beautiful and start being like, ooh, there's a lot of flies swarming around that. Vintage advertisements or advertisements. I'd like that, but I do feel, I don't know. I feel like that's kind of a shrug when I see it and I see someone's got like an old like ad. It just feels kind of like, I like the way this looks. And hey, so do I. Like, you know, I would love to just like plop that vintage poster of the Normandie, like, you know, in my house. But, I think it's probably a little too common. A colorful tablecloth. No.
How many framed editions of the 1985 Chicago newspapers can I fit in this kitchen?
So I'm thinking vintage vessels or something, right? Like, that'd be like cool decanter.
It is, and it's also a conversation piece, and it's also you can put these other things can be part of the vessel. You know what I mean? Depending on what the vessel is.
Oh wait, hang on. Nana Courtney, no accessories. Brutalist utilitarian kitchen. You know,
we're not one of those people. We're not. We're here to have fun. Or are we not?
all this is, though, like, it's like, all this implies a certain lack of function that bugs me. And I would like to, ideally, everything with that, like, a new gadget, if by new gadget you mean, like, cool coffee maker, sure, but it feels like that's not what they're talking about. I think none probably is the right move here. Pick a...
Oh, boy. Oh, boy. Well, again, we're trying to pick a... Rob, you have to remember, this is style. Like, this isn't actually necessarily representative of a thing in your kitchen. It's more... Oh,
they're trying to smoke out... They're trying to ethnic profile you. Like, who here is cooking French? Who here is, like, a health nut? Who here is, like, Hispanic or Asian? Who here is Italian? Like, I think this is, I think this is all very, these are suspect things. Like, this is like fucking Blade Runner, like, questioning, where it's like, you need a fat for cooking. Which one do you put in the skillet?
I cannot believe you would beseech the name of how so derogatorily Mr. Zachney.
Yeah, this is.
But also pick the cooking ingredient.
Okay, so I'm just going to say sea salt because, like, I use all of it. Well, I don't use saffron very much, but sea salt is, like, always got a little salt pig of that nearby. So, yeah, we'll do sea salt. Mm-hmm. Pick a palette. White and steel.
Hmm.
White and steel, brothers. Nothing but wood. Switch. Well.
That's how she got pregnant.
Nothing but wood. Wood and green. All gray, please. This is a weird way to put this. All gray, please. How about just whitewashed wood?
My question.
How about it?
I feel as though that's someone writing the quiz. And the edit, like, it was a suggestion. Like, can we put this one in here? And the editor... just left it with the original phrasing.
Black and white, wood and red, crisp white and green, as many colors as I can.
Colors I can fit. Yeah.
Wood and stone, red and yellow, soft blue, white and ocean blue.
I like. I mean, white and ocean blue. Like, I do like a good blue.
You like that? Like, you this picture.
I actually kind of like this photo. Like, this photo.
It ain't bad.
Doesn't look bad to me. But I don't know about Rob. All gray, please. No, that's the X-Files. That's what they call the aliens, the greats.
Yeah, I could. I guess this is kind of, I would say it's reductive in some weird directions, but sure. Let's say.
Wow, this is really giving Rob a lot to think about.
Yeah, it is. Wooden stone.
That does sound like an interesting,
yeah,
tonal mashup.
Where do you wish you lived?
Oh, hell yeah.
The rural country. The mountains. Suburbia. A big, bustling city. A historic neighborhood. An island. A warehouse district. The coast. I like to move around a lot. A small town, but not a remote one. An apartment above a cafe. South America. The Far East. A ranch. They don't got these in these other places.
Here's, like, the thing. This was written in 2014, so we can't even blame it on, like, the bad, like, geomedia AI, right? Like, unless they're backdating, I guess they could do that stuff, right? They could say it's from 2014, but the AI is writing it in 2023. This is, well, you don't like to move around a lot, or at least you haven't. So it can't be that.
I've had to, so I would like to avoid it. Like,
I gotta be honest. If you were to ask me from this list, what's Rob? It's a small town, but not a remote one.
I agree.
You would love the small town vibes. which is in many ways the appeal of suburbia, which well, is I think like
even
I have
like in cities you have small town vibes. Like my favorite places in cities have also been like, eh, it's a small little like main street we got here and a little downtown. Yeah,
right. Proper city neighborhoods can have the feeling of being in your own little town.
Yeah,
for sure.
Yeah, small town, not a remote one. That's a good poll. Pick a light fixture.
Oh, well, sorry, we never got to the rest of this stream because Rob never got past question 7.
Oversized wrought iron pendants. Brutal. Barn lights. Wicker lights. Mm-hmm. Something found and repurposed. Iron sconces.
What's a sconce? I'm looking at this.
Sconces. Like sconce lighting on walls.
I see. Yeah. Okay. I see. I gotcha.
Something dim and intimate. Something with frosted glass. Sleek pendants. Crystal chandelier. Something small and minimalist. Tiffany lamps. Can or puck lights. Something vintage. The more dramatic, the better. Does this thing predate LEDs?
2014, like probably the era of them. No, that doesn't predate LEDs.
No, but maybe it predates them being like really common fixtures.
Maybe, yeah, that could definitely be. Wow, this is really interesting. So that's what they call this style of art, Tiffany's. I didn't realize that. Like,
yeah, they're gorgeous.
Like the like, but also it's like the kind of stuff you see in a pool hall, you know, like,
yeah.
or is this one an Applebee's? I love this shit. I wouldn't want it all over my house, but I'd love it in my garage.
It's a good point. Stuff like the pool hall vibe or like the Applebee's is like, it's one of the areas where design trends from like the late 1800s and early 1900s just kind of like live on out of context.
And now it's also kind of died off because that whole era of, like, no one goes to the Pizza Hut. You just go, you know, they deliver your food. But it used to be a place where they had essentially, like, bar-style vibes for families. And I loved that growing up.
Pick a dessert.
What did you pick?
Oh, I picked something small and minimalist.
Okay. All right.
Because key thing, we measured my ceilings.
Mm-hmm.
7 feet high, 4 inches.
That's not very high.
No, it is not. It is not. I can like do this and I'm touching the ceiling. Like,
you can't even really put you can't even put fans around your place, can you?
No. No.
I mean, you can have, there are different styles of fans, right? Like there are fans that
only
press really high against the ceiling.
Yeah, you can have like really flush fans, but like not that flush.
No.
So like this is why minimalist fixture, like we're not putting a chandelier up there. No.
Yeah.
Pick a dessert, green tea ice cream, homemade pralines. Those are good. Organic fig tart, apples and brie. Something that requires dry ice, please. Who are you trying to impress? Almond flan, creme brulee, strawberry rhubarb pie, baklava, apple pie, peach cobbler, chocolate truffles, key lime pie, chocolate peanut butter pie. Okay, so apple pie is great.
It is.
But when I'm like, time to really treat myself, I want to make myself a disgusting little baker square pie and be a little fancy boy. It's like my special day.
I am always shocked at, is Baker Square a national chain or is that just a Midwest thing?
I wouldn't know. I don't think they're out here.
Baker Square is a like a family restaurant, like a fancy Denny's sort of thing. But they're also known for their pies. Market Square Bakehouse. So it doesn't look like it. People are saying they never heard of it. So it is a Midwest thing. It is like a fancy Denny's. And not even that fancy. It's just like, do you want to go... that's what a family style restaurant is. Like, it still has all the trappings.
We found the outer limits.
It's Michigan?
It's Ohio.
Ohio. That makes sense. But also it's like a bakery or like, you know, and so on Thanksgiving, I mean, Rob, there are cops out like surrounding the entire Baker Square to direct traffic because I have to assume it's more out of tradition then actually the Baker Square pies are that good, which is fine. Sometimes tradition tastes good, and that's all it needs to be. But, I mean, it stretches on for a mile, like a mile and a half, and they have to do specific traffic zones to get people, because the one of the Baker Squares near us is like right off a main road, and it's just wild. Every time I see it, I'm like, I want to try one of those, but then I see the line that's long.
Things are taking a turn, Patrick. Pick a parting phrase.
Hell yeah.
Farewell. All right. Uh-huh. Be seeing ya. Mm-hmm. Aloha. See you later, alligator. Bye, y'all. So long. Don't be a stranger. Sayonara. All the best. Take care. See you around. Adios. Au revoir. Ciao.
We just got a whole soundboard out of that, Rob. Reference the Kato back to this one.
I'm a big see around guy. No!
Cottage core. Trad Rob.
Oh no.
Wow, Hope MK, hoping know it's coming to you. Traditional housewife values in this home. You know what you asked for.
Your style is farmhouse. Simplicity is what you're after. You'll get that with reclaimed wood floors, open shelving, and vintage accents. Spring for an old-fashioned range for a jolt of nostalgia, and be sure to leave plenty of room for an extra-large table for dining and preparing fresh dough. Wash veggies from your garden in an apron front sink and look to freestanding cabinetry for additional dish storage.
See, the problem is if you just took out the farmhouse part, that really does kind of sound like a lot of the things that maybe you're looking for. Without the fact that looking back on the term pure white now takes on a wholly new categorization for where we've arrived.
Oh my God.
That's incredible. That makes me truly. All right, fun farmhouse kitchens with a sense of humor. Funny kitchen size, cute kitten decor. But yeah, we're going to. Oh.
This is farmhouse, people.
Oh my God. No. Can't you just have the aesthetic without this part? Like the wood, which is basically.
Yeah,
like
Joanna
wood?
Gaines. Joanna Gaines. Absolutely. Yes. Patrick, you need to understand. Like the entire art. Okay.
Oh, I know this. I've seen her. She does the fix up. Show, right? That's one of them that she does with her husband.
But wasn't she also the I might be thinking someone else. Who is the like did ceramics and is basically the person who like led the way on this style of like little farmhouse decor?
Someone says Joanna Hates, Hates. Is that possible?
Ray Dunn. Okay. So Ray Dunn.
Ooh, Berkeley. That's just making it
started making like years and years ago, started making like pottery in this style and would do things like it was cute at the time. It was kind of funny. It would be like not this shit, but it would be like you would have something that just says like flower or something, like little labels, little words on it. And it really starts catching on, and it basically informs what farmhouse style turns into. And this stuff gets getting like mass acquired by places like Pottery Barn. And so one of the things that's hard to separate from farmhouse at this point is like this shit, because it is so intertwined.
So she's not bad. She's bad, or the consequences of this aesthetic carrying on have taken like been adopted by like right wing evangelical.
I mean, she cashed in on it, but so would I. You know what I mean? It's like one of those things. Right. Where people could not get enough of this shit, so she you know, she met the market's need. Okay. And I do think, like, this shit would have been fun. Like, a piece would have been fun, but it turned into an entire, like...
lifestyle.
Yeah, exactly. And so this is, like...
So this lines up, like, very neatly or aided by or, like, intersects with the whole, like, far-right, like, traditional value, like, cottage... Like, all of that seems to, like, align around this. And I guess she gets caught up in... like use and like what is modern masculinity except so, to have a subservient wife that just loves to pump out kids and live in the dirt.
It's like I wouldn't say the farmhouse is necessarily tied up in all of that. I will say like farmhouse is really popular in like wealthy new developments where people go for this sort of style, and that does attract a lot of your right wing types, but it's an enormously popular decor style for kitchens and such. Like people just love it, and it does have like it is sort of appealing to this idea of tradition, but a lot of people outside of like weird right wingers like find a lot of comfort in that. And I think the thing I do find about it that is like affecting but not for me is that a lot of like farmhouse is always associated with a sense of like nostalgia. And, like, this is the sort of kitchen, like, grandma might have had, you know? And this is where... But, like, a lot of us didn't have grandparents who lived in places like this. It's an idea of a past that your family was, like, never really a part of. But it's this idea of you can create a comforting space that's, like, tied up in a deep sense of, like, belonging and, like, classic Americana.
It feels like history.
Yeah, but it's all
by virtue of aesthetic. Right, right. And, I feel like a lot of this is an extension of the kinds of stuff when you see it, like, a person's... lake house or something, like it's always better at the lake, you know, or like whatever. Yes, exactly. Like kind of stuff like that, but that stuff seems to always feel like kitschy in a fun way because it's a place you're like, it's a house not for living in, it's a house because you're going to quote the lake or whatever, but then bringing that home and making that part of your household, your family, like your daily infrastructure, it feels like that is I can see the slippery slope and how that starts to get pretty weird pretty fast.
So what you're describing, too, is coastal. So, like, the beach house vibe is, like, coastal style. And it is, like, farmhouse adjacent. And you actually do see some of the same terrible shit because, like, coastal, there's reasons that it's associated with, like, beach houses and such. Like, lots of rattan furniture, stuff that weathers well. But there's a lot of people who are like, I love the coastal style. And I think it would look great in my Duluth condo. And so you have like shit like that being done where it's like I'm gonna put seashells and yes, like anchor on a pillow type stuff.
But it's always in a like wealthy like family's second home lake house sort of like that, like that's the vibe that a lot of this goes for. I see.
So farmhouse not really for me. And I think
you say now and then your seventh quiz later. Is just Rob slowly coming to terms with the reality of his tastes and preferences. And or you could just make it look like a 1990s Pizza Hut and just really lean into the Tiffany lamps. I'm also okay with that. I mean, I guess you couldn't get a Tiffany chandelier, but there's lamps. We got options.
Ooh. Apolia. Who knows what that is? Top 10 Italian kitchen cabinets makers. Oh, look, they named themselves the top kitchen cabinet maker.
I mean, wouldn't you?
Yeah, I probably would, too.
What are,
feels like
your dream.
Established in 1994, headquartered in Guangzhou.
Oh.
Maybe doesn't feel... maybe not one of, like... one of these things is not like the other.
Everything else is.
But well, I'll bet you their shit is good, and I'll bet you it significantly undercuts the people on this list.
Ah, shit! The actors are going on strike.
Oh hell yeah! Get their asses.
Good for them.
I don't know. Maybe the producers should release more statements about how they want all the people they work with to die in poverty.
All that Bob Iger stuff. Do you see the quotes he had this morning?
I think it was like, I just don't know what they want type stuff. They're just asking unreasonable demands.
It's very disturbing to me. We've talked about disruptive forces on this business and all the challenges we're facing. The recovery from COVID, which is ongoing. It's not completely back. This is the worst time in the world to add that disruption. I understand any labor organization's desire to work on behalf of its members to get the most compensation and be compensated fairly based on the value that they deliver. We managed as an industry to negotiate a very good deal with the Directors Guild that reflects the value that the directors contribute to this great business. We wanted to do the same thing with the writers. And we'd like to do the same thing with the actors. There's a level of expectation they have, and it is just not realistic. Go fuck yourself.
All right, we're giving up here. We're going to IKEA kitchen cabinets.
All right, let's do IKEA kitchen cabinets, and then we should go to the thing. Yeah.
Well, okay. These kind of look. Do they have examples of like this stuff? Ideas and inspiration. Let's see. Rooms. Kitchen.
They have a kitchen builder. Maybe that's a stream for another day.
Yeah.
Where we can actually just like play with one of those things. But so I'd seen someone mention that there's an actual sort of like a kitchen planner. Maybe that's it. It's an app. Oh no, there you go.
No, you can do that. Start designing.
Wow.
Okay. This is all too optimistic about what we're dealing with here. let's call it an open kitchen space. And it's basically this. That describes the form factor of the kitchen. Okay, now. Yeah, there's no door here. That's not really what we're doing here. So we're just going to delete that. Ooh. And let's see. I think we got... There we go. Yeah, so let's get a couple elements in here.
Ooh.
Let's get some.
I just put in a gas pipe.
Yeah. Box object. Wait, you know what? Actually, hang on. When do I get to the throwing? Select an area for your kitchen. Area 2. There we go. Okay. Select and drag to rotate your room. Okay, got it. Yes. Cabinets. For corner. Let me have a nice cabinet. Oh.
That ain't all right. Bad. And look, we can see the price adding up. $800. Ding. $1,600. Ding.
Oh, how do we rotate this guy here?
This is pretty neat.
This is neat. There we go. Appliances. So here's where we got to get a oven.
High cabinet with oven. High cabinet for oven. I see.
Oh, that's not. No. That's not what I want here. We need a low one. We need like the oven goes ranges. Okay, so we just need something to sort of like fill in here with there we go. The Tvarsa. Anyway, we're gonna put the induction range in here. We're gonna delete that.
So that already kind of makes the financial part kind of misleading at the top because...
Yeah, a little bit here. Why can't we get you flush against the wall here, my friend? There we go. Okay. And sinks. Oh, this is a thing that I like. I would love to do is a corner sink for corner. No, that's not really a. Wall cabinets. Oh shit! We need the You gotta have the high cabinets to go above the range.
Of course. What would be the point otherwise?
Yeah, no, you got to. No, but those are all ground. That's where's the top pieces? That's the real question. I guess wall cabinets.
Oh, that sounds right.
Really weird. Yeah. Oh wait, here we go. So we're probably like much though. I would love to get rid of the old. Hang on. Hey, you go there.
Wow, Rob. So some of this stuff is filtering because part of the actor strike is that obviously productions are going to have to shut down.
Yeah.
But also it ends the promotional cycle as well. And so I guess the Oppenheimer premiere is happening literally right now in London, I believe.
Yeah.
And the BBC is reporting that Cillian Murphy and Emily Blunt at the premiere then left the premiere. That's fucking wild.
Oh my God.
Like they're straight up walking off. Like you understand, I would not necessarily call you a scab if you were like at the premiere of your big new movie, had gone through the press line, were sitting down to watch the movie. I don't know.
No, but is that the equivalent of like walking up to the producers and slapping them across the face though too?
It is.
You know what I mean?
I think it's baller. Like, I'm so glad that you have stars at that level for a movie that, by all accounts, is supposed to be awesome and, like, really distressing.
This promotional cycle is closed by order of the Peaky Blinders.
Well, Murphy's got more time to work on his farmhouse vibes. They're all going home to work on their IKEA kitchen simulators.
Okay, so I've barely started, and this is not really everything I would need, and so the appliances are a lot, but this shit's expensive, man.
I think that's the problem with kitchens, Rob.
Yeah, and also I should just mention that nothing in my apartment is flush and squared off, like the apartment tapers. So that's a bit of a problem too. Oh yeah, here we go. Cause I wanted to get a little, like a little spacer here to save room so I could like expand the, like have a bigger fridge. Cause right now ours is like really tiny.
Yeah, ours can never be any bigger than it currently is. There's just the spot for it that was carved out by the current cabinets.
Yeah, well, so we thought that too, but we're going after a wall.
Well, so that's there is you've never been to my house, but like there.
I find that very suspicious.
I met you in Chicago. I brought my I had one kid at the time down there. We met you. We went to Pequod's. Oh,
yeah, I know.
I have real
thoughts about that sequence.
Yeah, but you know what I'm talking about. Anyway, but like the big thing that we want to do eventually is, and it would require like a huge restructuring of the kitchen, is to knock out this wall that separates the kitchen and the family room, so that could all be one enormous space. So you could be prepping, it's especially useful with kids, where you could be prepping food in the kitchen while also keeping an eye on everything that's happening in the family space. But it requires a lot of work. Like you can't, it's not just take out wall. It's like take out wall and then, well, you've lost a bunch of storage space. How are you making up for that elsewhere? It's a whole thing. I've seen it done. It has been, any of the houses around us that are a similar type have been the first thing that they do when they remodel them or are trying to flip them is take out that wall.
Yes.
So you can get things like an island.
Okay, this is so I want to get one of these little fuckers in here. No. Well, you can just imagine it. You can just imagine it going back there. Just imagine Just imagine this thing sliding back there or something. Or I don't know. But okay, so this is IKEA. And also the thing, like, I need a corner cabinet sink here thing, you know, to save some space. We're at quite a bit of money, and this is for like the most basic IKEA stuff. And really, mm-hmm. you know, what I'm kind of dreaming of is stuff like Ark Linnea kitchen.
I feel like Rob, the IKEA stuff is maybe giving you an indication of the costs of doing any of this. Oh my God, look at that door.
This is how I could live.
With your wine cellar? Oh, that's cellar, but
oh, look at that. That's just like my place.
That looks awesome though.
Okay, yeah, all right. Like, look at this shit. Hey, nothing wrong with being a beta here. Hell yeah.
Fuck.
Okay, there's kind of a lot happening here. But I think this stuff looks great.
Yeah.
How much to buy your wares?
Oh.
Where to buy?
You think they sell collection? Is there a collection? Is that the
where to buy?
Rob, it's a bad sign when they don't show you the prices.
Uh oh, they don't appear to have any locations in Stati Uniti. They don't have showrooms. Okay. Well, they don't have prices. But Patrick, I think this is the part of our journey. I guess, you know, we'll have to bear in mind that farmhouse is something we could always fall back on.
Uh-huh.
But
okay.
I mean, yeah.
Hold on. I was trying to see if I could find any. There is one that has Ark Linnea Italia Kitchen, designed by and for Ark Linnea. It retails for $42,135. That's with cabinets, an island. That sounds about right. Aren't like kitchen remodel like
they're expensive. It's like the most expensive shit you can do. Yeah.
Right. Like $40,000. Is not
if that's
wildly out of character.
Hey, Lanini, so a down payment? No, man, no. It's not a down payment on a house. This is why this makes sense now. Time was that it's like, you know, $40,000 would be a decent down payment on a house, but not anymore.
Well, it's not just the down payment. Let's assume that's enough for the down payment, right? Because you can do, and we did this with our house for several years. We did 5% as opposed to 20%, right? And then we invested the rest of that 15% into like floors for the kitchen and other stuff. And then you play something called you pay essentially like a premium, an insurance, like $160 a month for like 4 years until we got that knocked off. Anyway, it's like the mortgage prices as well, right? Like there's a wild difference between paying like 3.5% and 7% on a fixed mortgage over 30 years. Like,
right.
Just the pure month to month cost is going up. Yes, private mortgage insurance, PMI. That's what we did with our house for a little while.
Principia or Principia. It looks great. But Patrick, I think this is all just like pointing out to make the kitchen of my dreams, we need to increase revenue.
Yeah.
We need to close some fucking deals.
Mm-hmm. Should we take that. You did think of that. Mm-hmm.
And it turns out we have some friends. We have some friends in high place. Well, middle high place. We got some friends at other companies, basically.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And one of those companies is NVIDIA.
Should we take a break, or are we just jumping right into this?
No. I think for our first dip into branded stream, I think it's time to crack into a little something.
What are you doing?
Oh, I'm just opening a little bottle of Prosecco.
Oh my God.
Oh yeah. There we go. Yeah, so shall we Patrick, you wanna explain to people what's going on?
Yeah, well, I feel like the when you switch the layout, it'll do a lot of heavy lifting.
Okay, all right. Say no more. Hey, get ready for commerce.
Or do you have to change our cameras?
No. I'm an OBS master, Patrick. Check this out.
Okay. Who's ready? Who's writing for some capitalism?
There we go. Yeah.
Yeah, we're taking it with the kitchen cabinet.
Okay, well, that's...
Was that on the sheet?
Yeah, this is... NVIDIA is sending me kitchen cabinets right away.
GeForce Now, so it is a service that actually, a number of years back, Rob and I were at the Vice offices, and I think GeForce Now had just sort of like started rolling out. Rob, as I'm setting this up, why don't you get over to the, you know, the spinny thing. We'll set people up. GeForce Now, which is, it's a streaming service. There's a number of them. And GeForce Now is one which kind of taps into your Steam library, your Epic Games library, your Ubisoft Play library, and allows you to remotely kind of jump in and play a bunch of games. And I remember we were at Vice. We were all in town for something. I can't remember what. Maybe it was like doing the holiday Game of the Year. Jesus Christ. Game of the Year recordings. I would like loaded up The Witcher on it, like on my like crummy Vice laptop on the notoriously bad Vice Wi-Fi, and showed it to you. I was like, this actually like works pretty decent, like on like several knocks against it, which is like a bad laptop,
yeah,
that runs really hot and loud, Wi-Fi that barely connects, and it looked pretty solid. And I'm pretty sure after that, you signed up and then played a game from your hotel room, right?
No, I finished Total War Three Kingdoms on GeForce Now on my laptop. Yeah. Like, won my first campaign of that.
Can you bring up the web browser first before we jump into...
Oh, sorry. I thought I had. Yes, people, I didn't hit the transition button. So, yeah, so we thought one of the things we were asked to showcase is GeForce Now started with, like, if it was on your Steam library, effectively, you could launch it through GeForce Now because it would be on a remote session. So you just log in on the remote computer and that would just work. And then there's some rights stuff that stuff got pared back. People weren't happy about that, the way that worked. We complained about it on the pod, like that it was kind of annoying that suddenly you couldn't just play your whole Steam library. But they've since expanded, like they've gotten a lot more games on the service for GeForce Now. It was one of the things that we were sort of asked to, you know, find a way of showcasing.
And I went into the lab. I spent most of a morning this week
making
in
this.
That lab. Making this. So on here is a wheel. There are 1,600 plus games on GeForce Now. I had to go to a lot of websites. I'll do this after I do this bit. I have to do some tweets. I had to go to a lot of websites in order to copy and paste, sometimes in batches, sometimes all at once, 1,600 entries, which is everything that's in GeForce Now. And I managed on this website to get every... So on there is every single game that's on GeForce Now. And as part of a series of streams we're going to be doing, partnered with NVIDIA, is in addition to like briefly checking out some of the games that are new on the service, we are going to spin this goddamn wheel, and whatever it lands on, we're going to test their service out, because I have a Steam account that can add any game to my account, which adds any game to Rob's account, which lets us spin this wheel.
And we're confident-ish that's going to work.
So Rob, while I send some tweets, can you spin this goddamn wheel for people?
Oh, I can spin this wheel.
Thank you.
Where will she stop? Nobody knows, folks. Where will the G-Force Now wheel conclude its journey? Look at it go. Wait, it's going backwards now. Is it, it's spinning backwards? It's still spinning, folks. And it's slowing down. We're almost ready.
When I first created this wheel, I had it spin for 30 seconds, and then I said, that's not long. It needs to be 60 seconds. What is it gonna be? What is it gonna be? So unfortunately, that's not the game we're gonna play first. But I wanted to show the wheel. Oh,
thank God. Thank you, God.
I wanted to show the when the wheel but it's so funny I might have to make you do it, so I'm gonna think about it. But the game, so this is the wheel, and this is gonna be the structure of these streams that we're gonna be doing on Thursdays for a couple of weeks. But I it is shocking the degree. We're a little nervous about doing something like this. We've never done something like this before. We wanted to make sure it was fun for the audience and like we were giving you something that felt in line with the stuff that we do. And so the wheel is a part of that. And also, as though it was the world looking down on both of us, Rob, and saying, it's okay. Take that bag. It was the fact that this week of all weeks, there are two games that have been added to GeForce Now. One, Jagged Alliance 3, which we would have played today, but it's not actually out yet. It's not available until Friday. The other game is Dragon's Dogma Dark Arisen. And so, Rob, please, for the people, a game I know you have not played, but have sat through so many podcasts listening to me, Austin, now Ren, who has gotten into Dragon's Dogma, could you please, for the people, and for the fine folks at NVIDIA. And also in the chat, I believe, can you test it for me? If you do exclamation GFN, I believe it should give you a link. I think I set up the bot correctly. Yeah, if not, apologies to NVIDIA.
Uh-oh, I don't see a robot talking.
No, learn more about GeForce Now.
Okay.
At link, I did it. Look at Kato. You can't see it, but somewhere you're out there on the countryside. Wherever you're having your vacation.
I can't believe it. Pat, like, people are not mollified by Dragon's Dogma, Patrick. People are upset because Dota 2 is not being launched.
They're going to have to wait. You're going to do Dragon's Dogma.
All right.
It's new on the service this week. We're going to test that out. And then, fine. The people have asked. The wheel has demanded. Rob will play Dota 2. I think we're going to try and play the games on the wheel for like 30 minutes and then spin again. But Rob, take it. Let's load up Dragon's Dogma. That was already in my account, so you should be good to go. And I think you should be able to jump in and play.
Yeah, I am just so I would like. You're probably not getting the full GeForce Now experience because there is a remote session aspect of this, so it's launching through the Steam client. Actually, there's nothing private on the screen, so you can just sort of see that it's like I'm logged into Steam on a remote machine here, and it's launching. And I haven't used this in a minute, so like I don't know what the
Rob, I'm gonna need you to hit a transition button for the stream,
oh,
please.
Yeah, yeah.
The wheel refuses. Can you stay on this title screen? Please don't hit a button.
Okay.
Because I think the title screen music. I have not played Dark Arisen. This is an expansion to Dragon's Dogma. I need to change our Twitch stuff, which I'm going to do while we're waiting for this to happen.
People are saying if there's a song you're waiting for to drop, they removed it.
They removed it! Inferior,
yes.
Music! That's really unfortunate to hear. All right, Rob, go ahead and hit play and get in there while I change
people are
this
still
up.
So mad about Dota.
Well, because I mean, I get it. I get it. We're going to get there.
This is Die or Tie Give all over again. So, there is one thing we should bear in mind. Patrick is parsecing into my PC so that he can see what I was doing on the browser and so he can see all this. So, the thing that might not be optimal for a service like GeForce Now in this setup is that probably most of the time you're on GeForce Now, you are not streaming to yourself to play a game, streaming out to a colleague, and then also streaming out to Twitch. That's probably not your usual use case.
But Rob, we are stretching the limits of this spectacular service. What is it capable of? Well, I'm sure there are people who would play on GeForce Now while doing screen sharing on Discord to a friend, right? So I think like while we may be using Parsec, I assume like that could be an absolutely normal use case.
Oh god. Okay, it doesn't follow your cursor. I was like, is this broken? Okay. New game.
All right.
Yes, that is true. We have the ultimate membership here that does have the 4K 120 FPS thing.
Yeah, there are multiple kinds of memberships that get you access to I should just look that up, right, Rob?
Absolutely. Like
I should tell the people accurate information about that.
Do I want normal or easy?
Just put it on easy for the sake of this. Eh, put it on normal.
All right. A vast arm. Well.
Robert loaded so fast that you couldn't even read that loading screen.
I thought maybe that was a title screen, but this is the real title screen. A child of man blazes your path. How dark it got. Have you a light
source? Yeah, so there's a free membership, which is, you know, you get servers. You get access to basically to play for an hour. There's like a priority membership where you get access to 6-hour sessions at 1080p, 60 frames a second, and you do get the RTX, the ray tracing stuff on. That's $10 a month, or $9.99 a month, or $50 for 6 months. Ultimate, which is what we are currently streaming and playing on, is up to 4K. You get 120 frames a second, or you can do 1080p at 240. And it has something, you know, I'm sure there's trickery and tech, what they call ultra low latency. But on certain devices, I guess that's not every single device that you use. And you can play for up to 8 hours. And also that priority session is 6 hours. So like as you go along the different memberships, basically like the games look better, run faster, and all that good stuff. But the dragon's roost is just beyond. Jones Zones. Is this an ad? Look. This is just Remap stretching its arms around this great country and all it has to offer. And sometimes what this great country has to offer
is a branding deal.
Is a branding deal where it has Rob Zachney playing Dragon's Dogma. Do you think there's a world that I got Rob Zachney playing Dragon's Dogma in any other? Also, I want to point out, Rob is playing Dragon's Dogma with a mouse and keyboard. I really don't think this game is meant for that.
Feels pretty good. Oh, shit. We got time to dragon was like nil. Yeah, it sure as shit shows itself.
Someone in the chat's like, you should add hashtag ad to the title. I'm like, do you have to do that? I don't know what these just... I added it, because I don't want to get in trouble. Stay away from me, pesky government. I'm here to start streaming on GeForce Now. The FCC says yes. And you know what? We here at Remap, we love the FCC.
No, the FCC sucks. The FTC is the good one. The FCC sucks. But on this one area, they're on to something. But I'm not sure I have to say the ad thing because like there's branding all over it. The thing that the like you have to clarify it's an ad thing was specifically about people being like, oh, here's this product I'm just using, and they were not making clear like influencers were not making clear. That it was for that. People are saying they're hearing double game audio. Here, Arisen, go and touch that stone. Patrick, do you hear? Are you?
I would have to mute myself and listen to the stream.
Okay.
See, the power of GeForce Now is just that it can give you not just one audio. Where would you be getting two audio?
No, so the problem is I'm not like readily sure how to solve this because I am hearing. You know what it is? Okay, hang on.
I'm hearing that Rob has an idea.
No, but that might have just killed it. Yeah, so now you don't hear it, right?
A gateway to the rift. Here. Arisen, go and touch that stone. No, I think the game audio is there. It's hard for me because I'm trying to listen to the stream, but also I'm listening to
you. Okay, hang on. So now you should only hear... The doubling should be okay.
Mondo Michael, how do I feed Patrick ice cream stickers so he goes lick, 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 yes, yes, thank you. Have you seen this stuff?
I've seen these videos, yes.
It's very upsetting.
Yeah.
Very upsetting.
FCC ain't making them say these are ads.
Well, Rob, when you eat yourself, become the ad.
Wait. What the fuck is happening? I went up this stone, people fell out of it. Okay. Yeah, they're here now. Pawns. They're pawns.
The pawns are sick. The pawns are one of the most defining features of the Dragon Dogma. Like, what is that clicking sound? It's Rob's keyboard.
Wait, I didn't tell them to leave, did I?
Rob is playing with a mouse and keyboard in Dragon's Dogma. Oh my! I'm not sure it's ever...
My pawn just threw a high explosive barrel at me? I thought they were helping. Oh god. Are you kidding me? Wait, what? What do I do?
The game audio is pretty messed up on the stream.
That's odd. What are they hearing? Okay, wait. Honestly, I've got the fan in like whisper mode,
but is it this?
Is it the fan hitting the mic?
No. I fear the whole of no, people are saying it's like it's playing twice with this very small delay. Somehow you're piping audio through twice. How would that be?
That's a great question. The audio is doubled, which I can see how that is happening. I just don't know why.
Calidrum, it's like the game audio is being picked up by an empty room mic. Are you playing audio too? No, I am. I mean, I can mute everything that I'm hearing except for Rob. And then... Wait, hold on. Rob.
Yeah.
Just keep going. See if it fixed it.
Oh yeah, nothing ever goes wrong when Kato's here.
Doesn't that sound fixed? Yeah, this is not a GeForce Now problem. 100%. I when I am getting
Yeah, I think it's a so. I think this is an OBS problem.
Oh, okay, Ed2Dead says, Pat Rob, could you try muting their mics for 5 seconds and see if we still get game audio? Would tell us if it's picking up from a physical device.
Yeah, it's. I don't think it is, but I can mute my mic.
Right this way.
Same issue. Okay. Okay. I love this. Real-time troubleshooting. Do you have like the stream open somewhere? Like, is it somehow pulling in? No. Also, Rob, you've muted yourself to the audience.
Yeah, so it is.
People probably, if the stream was open, the delay would be longer. This is like,
no, like so, no, so let me tell you what this is. So the issue is, for me to hear the game, I have the, so I am hearing the game audio through OBS that the capture card is picking up.
Uh-huh.
But I think then, because that is also playing through the audio device for my desktop, it is being doubled through that. So like I'm hearing the game through OBS, but that is playing through my desktop audio, which is being output, and that is what the stream is using to hear Patrick, but it is also catching the output of the game audio.
So I followed most of that. Basically, in order to hear the game, you think that's what's causing this double.
Yeah, so I think this might be a VB cable situation. So I'm going to open the mixer.
Oh, we're gonna go that deep into the fixes here.
Yeah.
Could you just mute the audio for yourself and see if that fixes it?
Because if I mute it for myself, nobody will hear it. So let me see here. Okay.
Crunchy go OBS likes multi-channel audio. I mean, it also might have something to do with like your monitoring. Like I know that'll sometimes happen with me when I'm streaming with Kato, and Kato has to go in and change like how OBS handles what it's pulling from and what it's feeding back to you. I just don't know. I wouldn't know what to tell you and how to.
Yeah. So do people still hear the game? Hang on. Do people hear? No, they don't. So. The minute I mute monitoring on this, it also stops putting.
No, they hear the game. They hear the game.
Okay.
Is game good? Game sound okay? It's fixed.
Oh.
Okay, people say the audio sounds good now. You did it, Rob. That's
well, that's great. Production. But like, I can't hear it, which is so it's like a fix for the stream, but it's not. It's not
a long term fix. This is
part of that like audio cable bullshit, which always strikes me as like a terrible solution.
Well, because you're faking a mixer, right? Like, I mean, that's essentially what you're doing on a it. it sort of is wild that for as important as streaming has become and mainstreamed in people's lives, that there isn't better, like, integrated OS level stuff for that. You know, that just feels like, heck, that's something I'd pay for. Like, Windows AV or whatever that, like, had a better set of that.
Man, we're just, like, massacring these goblins, though, man. Oh. Wow, so that's just a thing. Like, so your buddy is just like, hey, want to come kill this guy?
Mm-hmm. And so the pawns are, like, the uniqueness of the pawns in Dragon's Dogma are, like, how do I put this? So they, well, they do lack emotion and true will. So, I mean, you know, they've got that going for them. But if I remember correctly, because it's been a while since I played Dragon's Dogma, chat can help me out here. Like, they go off and have their own adventures, right? Like, is it pulling just from your friends list, or is it completely from strangers as well? But, like, your pawns will come back, like, upgraded with new powers, because they've gone and had adventures with other people in the game world.
Oh, I don't like the thought. But then it's like when your friends all, like, play a game and you don't play with them and they're way ahead of you.
What do you mean? No, your pawns are your just, like, companion characters.
Yeah.
You want them to be... They bring stuff back, right? Don't they bring, like, loot back with them? Like,
yeah,
no,
but
it's
I don't want
sick.
To feel like my friends are just, like, they're my friends who, like, go raiding and they're just, like, hard carrying me through the game.
They're not. That is, Rob, that is, like, not at all, like, you will not make any progress in this game unless you are... Your companion is not going to make this game on easy mode.
You know this is good fantasy when they start calling the dragon the worm with a Y. There is a little tearing here that I am seeing. I am curious. Variable? Does that seem right?
Do you want to turn VSync on? I barely even know what that stuff does. VSync on variable frame rate, probably. So variable plus VSync.
All right. And now... Sure.
Oh, Avalio says it syncs your VS. Okay. All right. That makes.
Thank you. Yes.
see, Butter Basil's got what I do, which is VSync is the thing that you turn on and off when something is wrong and you hope it fixes it. Yes,
right.
That is what I do.
Sometimes
it's
like, the tearing's happening. VSync is failing. Sometimes it's like tearing is happening. I need to turn on VSync.
Yes. Like I've read explanations on how it all works before and. It's the equivalent of, like, turn it on, turn it off.
Our army is routed.
Because you got your G-Sync, your V-Sync. Are there other syncs? In
FreeSync.
Is that an AMD thing? Or is that...
It is. Now... I don't know what. Oh,
Bro, the chat points out, Rob. Also, kitchen sink, SYNC.
Oh my God, get wrecked, Aslan. Hey, what the? Wait, hang on. What's going on with this creature?
Don't worry about it. There's creatures.
Yeah, no. I don't like this.
Well, I mean, don't tell that creature how to
Hey, Morgana just got, like, demolished here. Am I not? Hey, guys. Oh, boy. Is there a lock-on thing here? Because I feel like I want to be oriented toward this. I guess I'll just... Hey. Ooh. Oh. I bet that sounded awesome. Wait, now there's a snake in the picture?
There was always a snake.
Look, I was so distracted by the ram that I kind of missed that. Well, they're just getting right up there, huh?
Can you climb? Yeah, you can climb. That is the defining feature of the Dragon's Dogma.
Well, I didn't. Now I'm getting fucking eaten.
Just jump. Like the song. Oh, you have to grip it. Rob, I don't know what this
What's
is.
What's the grip
on a,
button?
On a keyboard?
Use F to
I'll look it up.
F? Okay, people are saying it's F. Wait. Yes, get his ass, Salde. Yeah. All right, now I'm on it.
All right, now get up there. So a huge part of this game is slashing in like specific parts of the creatures and getting on like these giant monstrosities, including the griffins that can take you into the sky.
Oh yeah,
like
okay.
It's really exciting.
Yeah, now I'm just like on him.
But it also puts your character in the most hilarious positions where you're just like gripping this leg and wildly flailing a sword around. Does Rob know how to use his abilities? No.
Yeah, I do.
Does Rob have ability? Are you using abilities?
Yeah.
Okay. My face is covering up all the keyboards or the mouse button prompts in the corner. More like this.
I'm using my left control, my right control.
Over here.
Alt control. Mm-hmm. Oh wait, is this healing? Am I healing? Something good's happening there. Hey, Patrick, I feel kind of bad for how we're just, like, killing the shit out of this beautiful creature. Like, I know it's trying to kill us, but, like, this thing's magical as hell, man.
Yeah, I gotta, you know, if that isn't an initial concern in this game, you might have some problems going forward in Dragon's Dogma. What if, like, the creatures were bigger and more beautiful and more majestic, and then you also killed them?
Yeah, that doesn't sound good. I
Oh, but they're bad. You're told. The village people are scared, Rob. Destroy them.
All right, we did it, gang.
Oh, yeah, Miss Roystead points out something that I forgot about the lore of this game, which is that that creature was a fascist. Like, you just didn't know it.
Yeah, okay.
I'm just going to tell... Chat, for the purposes of this stream, we're just going to tell Rob that all the creatures are fascists, and so he can just... We want to make sure he keeps going. Merc the Jerk, is this Rob's first time? Yes, this is the first time Rob has actually played Dragon's Dogma.
And what a way to play it.
What a way to play. I mean, Capcom is constantly sending emails to its influencers. Please. Like, people don't believe us that the mouse and keyboard is the way to play this gamepad-specific game.
Sound is actually just distracting you from the beautiful game.
Is there a reason I forget how, like, the audio routing made it more complicated, but, like, I guess to hear me, you wouldn't be able to just plug a cord into your monitor to listen to the game audio, because then you wouldn't be able to hear me anymore.
Yeah, no, it... This is where the virtual cable thing comes in, because it's like, I can hear everything, but then you can have it so that the, like, it only plays through the cable, like, once, rather than having, like, that slight doubling.
I think that might be an OBS issue, frankly.
No, 100% is an OBS issue. Like,
I believe it is like a drop down menu in your audio properties and changing how it's monitoring. And that would probably fix it. It's kind of thing that if Kato was here,
so
they would be able to fix it in 30 seconds. But Kato's enjoying a vacation. Rob is sacrificing the audio and we're figuring it out. We're charging forward regardless. It's very funny. It's like the virtual cable is to create a virtual way to handle like audio mixing management. We're struggling with that on a service that streams like video games through like a box sent to your box. That part's working fine. GeForce Now, crushing it, no problems. Like playing Dragon's Dogma Dark Arisen without issue. It is not Nvidia's fault that our audio routing is slightly goofed. So who's the name? Bob? Oh, hi, Bob. Dave Provost suggests the name of GeForce, GApostrophe FORCE.
Hey, in honor of our friends at GeForce, let's go by Ada.
Wait, why? What's? I don't understand.
I believe their architecture is currently the Lovelace architecture.
Oh, okay. Nailed it. Love a good reference from Rob that I don't understand that I have to ask in front of the audience.
Oh, wait, I can be all these guys?
Yeah, select your body, baby. Who do you want to be?
Sup.
Be that little child. Be this guy.
I love when he interviews Aaron Rodgers. Honestly, this guy looks how I feel a lot of the time. Mm-hmm, like, that mm-hmm. dude...
Yeah,
that
let's go.
Dude takes a
Please.
Few minutes to straighten up after getting out of bed.
Yeah, yeah. That guy feels like how my back has felt for the last yep. couple days with a herniated disc. But been doing my exercises, and this morning I did a podcast. And the thing about a herniated disc when it flares up and you gotta do your exercises to strengthen those lower back muscles, like when sitting in the chair like this, I feel fine. And then 2 days ago, if I was to get up from this position after this stream, I would just melt to the floor and then just I can't actually stand up straight without extreme pain. And I did a podcast this morning, stood up without issue. I was like, yes, crushing it. Cat pose.
Real quick, I need to be told what's a good voice here.
Oh, okay. I can help.
Whoop. Wait. Back?
Make more detailed edits?
No, that was like for like really customizing.
Then edit basic information?
Back? Edit basic. Voice, yes.
Yeah, there we go. Voice. Okay, hit me.
All right,
Mm-mm.
No?
Mm-mm. Mm. Keep going. That was... Type 6 was pretty good. Another one. Ooh, type 5, that was alright. Okay. Mm, no. Type 7? Okay, type 7 might be my favorite yet. Type 8? No. Okay, type 7 or type 9. Keep going. All right, type 12 is now currently in the lead. Type 11.
Hey, chat, what are the vibes? Sorry, I don't trust Patrick fully.
Hit me. What was 11? Do 11 again. Ooh, that was... All right, chat, 9 or 12. Yeah, sorry. You're gonna have to go with 12. Rob, do you want to turn the audio back on for yourself for
sorry,
a second?
Let me just.
You don't get to change the choice. But you can hear it.
Do you still hear that? Do you still hear the voice?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Oh, but it's doubling for you, right?
Or well, I'm not listening to the stream. Chat yeah. will have to
Wait, what? They're all babies.
No. No, they're not. Wait, people are saying there's no doubling? All right, let's just leave it this way and see if... Was it as simple as turning it on and back off again? I mean, sometimes that's
this
what
is
it
a
is.
Thing I tried like first. This is the first thing I chose.
Okay, well, who knows?
People really want this fucking baby.
Yeah, they do. Rob, pick 12 and move the fuck out of your life.
Okay, Jesus.
The people want Dota, and the longer you sit on this audio stream, is the do I need to add? I probably don't need to add Dota to my Steam account. I think I played it once when I worked at Giant Bomb. It's also free, so I guess that part doesn't.
Yeah, no, I have Dota. That will launch, no problem.
Okay, all right. I'm just double checking.
Wait, how do I get out of here? Okay, so confirm.
Sleepy the Bear. We are playing Dota, Dogma of the Ancient. That's true. All right, well, let's check out the beginning of this so we can see your character.
Well, people are upset that Dragon's Dogma is going to make a bad impression on me because of this first introduction. Is it going to be the keyboard and mouse? You forget, I was a keyboard mouse gamer exclusively forever. Like, I have done things. I have had play experiences you can't imagine. It's really important that you be able to control how fast your dude walks, and that only happens with a thumbstick.
I mean, yeah, there used to be PC ports that didn't have gamepad support, right?
Yeah.
And yeah, players would hack things into it using mapping tools, but that doesn't mean that you would get the full support like the way you get things now. For people just joining, we're playing this on GeForce Now, which is NVIDIA's cloud computing service. We're playing it on the GeForce Ultimate, but there are a number of different
tiers. Is GeForce Now making these people look this way? Or is this just how the game looks?
Rob.
These are some weird fucking faces, man.
Rob, this is a game from 2008.
Wait. This is that old?
Yeah. Faces were different back then. Don't you remember 2008 faces?
Do you remember how you looked? Wait, didn't we just fight a dragon? Now there's another one?
Yeah, but this is like the bad one, I think.
I thought the other one was bad.
I think this one is going to steal your heart, is what happens here.
Oh. I'm ready for love.
So we're streaming this on a Thursday because Thursdays is also when NVIDIA adds new games to the library. Like, hilariously enough, we didn't time it this way. It's just the way it worked out. Like, we are doing this first partnership stream with NVIDIA when they added Dragon's Dogma with Dark Arisen. And it's not like, hey, can you tell us the games you're rolling out for the next month under embargo so that we can figure out the one that makes the most sense? It'll be fun for our audience. Help sell them on this idea. No, this is just the game that we found out the night before or 2 days before, like, will be on the service. Just incredible. Sometimes things just line up for us, Rob.
People are helpfully telling us this dragon is even more of a fascist.
Oh, yeah. He's got that energy.
This dragon donated to Trump.
I mean, yeah, there's donating to the Republican Party, and then there's donating to Trump. Like, that's
is
that's
there
true.
Yeah, I don't know if that distinction holds as much as it used to. All right, I got this.
Challenge this dragon. Challenge him. You look ready. Look at this guy. Look at this.
Oh,
little,
yeah, he's got
man.
He's got dad energy. He's like you know how like you hear stories about like parents just going batshit and like lifting a minivan up.
Oh, that's so good.
Oh, hell yeah. Kiss, 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 kiss.
Like, Larian only announced that you could make love to a bear. I don't think they've announced like the full suite of animal loving. Is it talking to me?
That sounded draconic. I don't think those were words.
Yeah, a little. That had some. Had a little bit of Necronomicon vibes from Evil Dead.
I touch you. I'm not touching you. He's totally touching him now.
Look, you put a little sword in his hand. He takes your heart. You know, that's a fair. That's a fair trade.
I wonder if that's like popcorn chicken for dragons or something. Like,
I like that he still has the wherewithal to be upset about the consumption.
This is great Last of the Mohicans. This is a great Last of the Mohicans reference, honestly.
And that's Dragon's Dogma. Rob, I think we might have to give the people. Like, I'd love to watch you play more Dragon's Dogma, but the wheel spoke. We listened to the wheel around here.
Well, hang on.
This is gonna what?
My character's just dead?
No. I think you're just
wait.
You're
what, wait, hold on.
Now.
Whoa. Shouldn't there be a gaping chest wound for that dude? He's fine.
Yeah, your fate
is
now.
This is like that David Duchovny Mini Driver rom-com. Return to me. Take up
arms. No leaving. What was that movie from like 15 years ago that was like a dragon? Like a serious dragon movie. But like the dragon gets unleashed in New York. Is that Christian Bale? What is you know what I'm talking
about? Is
that
Pete's Dragon?
No.
How to Train Your Dragon?
Rain of Fire. Rain of Fire.
Oh.
Is that movie good? A lot of no's. A lot of no's in the chat.
But can we believe them, Patrick?
No. I think the only way to do that is to just rewatch that film for an arbitrary reason.
Please, everyone be alive. Yeah, they're moving. They're moving. Oh, character creation. Hang on, Patrick. We got to do a little character creation. Because this is like, what's this dude all about?
Uh-huh.
The way he grabbed that sword, he just feels like he's ready to throw down.
Now, I will say, like, mage... Well, to do the arrow stuff, is that... the arrow stuff is the coolest stuff in this game. Just forget how that works, which if that's class specific or yeah, you want this. You want to be a Strider. Strider is the class in Dragon's Dogma.
All right.
100%.
All right. So
exit. It's like you do Strider class and then you like scale along mage in terms of I mean you can do both, but that's the like when you see people, like if you ever seen like the clip of, you know, someone shooting like 1,000 magic arrows into the sky and then raining down, like that is often the character they are playing.
Hey, wait, talking to the guy. Hey. Hey, you talking to her? Hey, what's good, buddy? Been dead for 30 seconds?
I gotta be honest, Rob. Your character does not look like the world savior. Like, there's nothing about this guy that makes me think that I should bet on this horse. Lost his heart. I'm not sure I would have betted him before the whole heart loss part.
Well, you know, maybe he's like he's a tough old bird, right? You know, this is a guy who's like settling into a nice retirement. And...
Wishful star, Rob's character melted Bryan Cranston.
Is this my first foe?
Your first foe is love.
You should be abed. I wish you would not strain yourself so. I am worried for you, cuz.
Sorry, ma'am. I misunderstood the nature of our connection. Have a good one. I will simply acknowledge that I could not hear what was being said in the intro of that. Anyway, have a good one, cuz. Don't be alarmed by the fact that your zombie cousin is, like, hanging. Okay, you know, for 2008, though, you know, this is kind of cool.
You don't have to, no convincing required. I was one of the people out there telling folks that Dragon's Dogma was extremely interesting and cool back then. I stand by that. I haven't played it in a long, long time. And didn't get around to Dark Arisen, which you will not either, because it's a Dark Arisen, if I remember correct. I don't know if it's a post-game or late-game expansion, but it's certainly not anytime soon. 2012.
Okay, so Patrick, I think, yes, you wanted to get to some Dota?
Yeah. I'm gonna need you to close this, and I'm gonna need you to play 30 minutes of Dota, or as long as you can stand. The wheel spoke. The wheel is, it has every game from GeForce Now on there. There's 1600 games. You can play it the way we are playing it, which is through a downloadable PC app. But you can also play it on your Mac or your Chromebook. Like, if there's a browser window, you can do it on your iPhone and iPad. Even though there's not a native app, you just load it through the web browser and it'll take up the screen, and you can do it that way. There it is. No. Yeah. Continue. Yep. No, hit the, yeah. I know that cancel was the green button, and that looked awfully appealing, Rob. But I'm gonna need you to.
What's that little reflex square mean?
I don't know.
I don't think I should be playing with people.
So this is the interesting part, but whenever you play with one of these services, right, it's like they
reflex. They means it's NVIDIA Reflex for ultra low latency, which I'm gonna need to show my true Dota skills.
Well, we had mentioned that earlier, that there are certain. Just got a message from Brad Shoemaker asking me what I'm doing. I'm not sure what Brad might. Brad, what could you be referring to? Is it?
Okay, so we. I think we have encountered a little glitch. It's running, but we're stuck in the. Here we go. Okay, that is too many. How do I hide this? Because that is my whole friend's list.
That's a great question. Oh, I'm away.
Yeah, and so should everyone. Okay, so Dota Plus. Yeah, let's see here. Okay.
What's Dota Plus?
Dota 2.
You need a phone number associated with your account to get ranked matchmaking?
We want to max this out, right?
I would click everything. Where's the select all button? And for the record, if you're just tuning into this, so the reason we're playing Dota is not to curse Rob, but we built a wheel That has all 1600 games that are supported on GeForce Now. It was like, well, how do we pick what to play? And I loaded all 1600 games and we spun it once. And the game that it landed on was Dota.
All right. How do I get into a bots match through this? That's the first question here. Play Dota.
Play versus bots.
Solo. Default bots. Bot difficulty. Let's, you know what? Hell yeah. Absolutely. Hey, wait. When do I pick my hero? Oh, thank God. Is there a sort thing? Can I... items. Do I need items? Healing salve seems good. Oh wait, no, this is... Yeah, how do I buy that? Yes, I will buy all that. See, I'm a veteran. I first played this game back in 2012.
Look, there's a lot of these. The characters all kind of play the same, though, right? So it's like you just kind of figure out how to click one of them, and then...
In Dragon's Honor.
Okay. Rob, have you ever played this game?
Yeah. I'm a huge Dota head.
Okay.
Prepare for battle.
I need no steed.
Okay, I guess...
How do you center your character? Where's your character? Oh, there he is.
Well, nobody was going to... Should I be down in bottom lane or should I be in mid? Now they're converging on mid, so hang on.
Yes.
All right, I guess I'll go over here, y'all. Jeez.
Didn't we play with Kato once? Did we? Then I purged that from my memory banks. I believe you that it's absolutely possible. The last time I remember playing Dota 2 was like in the thralls of Brad Shoemaker being deeply into it when I was at Giant Bomb. Yes. And we did a stream where we loaded it on a bunch of computers and played together. I don't remember anything of that experience. Wait, Kato. Kato, are you in the chat right now? What are you?
Wait, what's
Kato?
What's Kato doing?
Wow, Brad's in the chat as well. I don't like. You know what? Kato's on vacation. Brad should just keep his mouth shut.
Wow.
And, the power of Dota. Did we put up some sort of smoke signal, Rob? Did the wheel put up some sort of smoke signal?
Oh, hell yeah. Yes. All right.
Yes. The dragon wait.
So why did you pick the Dragon Knight, Rob? What about this character called to you?
I should have waited until... Because I remember I was told he was easy enough to learn on.
Okay, so we're talking like a Ryu Ken situation, more of a generic sort of starter character. So you are right now fighting what they call the ads, right?
Yeah.
Getting the powers...
Yeah, and I'm trying not to take, like, because I want to, like, what I remember is you kind of want to sustain in lane a bit, but I also can't really, I have no sense of timing on any of this here.
You did not watch Arcane, did you? The show?
No.
It was awesome. That show was great. I mean, I know that's not Dota, but... Arcane was really good.
Higher honor. We cross swords.
Dota had a show as well? That adds up. Oh, there was like a Netflix anime, right? Something like that? I vaguely remember that.
Swiftly.
Rob, a lot of people are saying last hit
Yeah, no, they are. But that's like, it's foundational to this, and also it's like hard. So Patrick, like, what they are alluding to is, I get gold if I deliver the last hit on these monsters.
I see.
But it's kind of a moving target, because as you level, you do more damage. And so when you would get the last hit begins to change.
I need...
No! Uh-oh.
Oh, that seems bad.
That is bad. I am... Oh, they're diving. Shit.
The dragon waits.
Oh, thank God. My donkey friend is coming.
You know, the last words I want to hear before I take my dying breath.
Hang on, I just got you the tree real quick.
What?
Missing bottom.
All good.
Yes. This will only hurt a lot.
You ate a tree?
Yeah, trees are good for you. It's like vegetables.
Well, I love trees, but... I heard on a podcast recently, there's a podcast sponsor going around where they like send you trees.
Yes,
that doesn't heard any sound. Of these? That doesn't sound right.
You get to pick which tree you want.
Which ones does this do here? Okay.
To help you keep it healthy.
Damn it! All right, that ability doesn't do shit. Uh oh. Okay.
Wormblade cuts deep. Powers abounding. Wormblade cuts deep.
The Wormblade cuts deep, Patrick. I think we got like two last hits this entire game. Oh, what we got going on over here?
Well, because you're using the gold to get your extra powers, right? Upgrade? You buy things in between rounds or deaths?
So the reason people like the donkey is, like, I believe you can buy things in the store and have the donkey come deliver them to you. This game was like an early forerunner of the gig economy. it like anticipated where things were going, to be honest. Oh
gold
shit!
To
like
buy item. Yes. And your courier brings them to you. I see.
Yeah.
Donkey, bring me my potions.
I need those steed.
We'll see why he doesn't need a steed in a few minutes here, Patrick.
Does everybody get a donkey?
Yeah.
Like donkeys for all? Like a socialist donkey?
The dragon.
It's a little bit of like
escapee one donk dash.
We cross swords.
I feel like we're causing psychic pain to Kato right now.
Probably
like, I won't even know. How did Kato even realize that we were doing this? Like, I didn't see Kato in the chat during Dragon's Dogma.
So there's got to be a way to buy things here, right? So donkey.
Oh yeah,
store,
there's a donkey. Get some
store
stuff.
Store starting items. Early game.
Spend all your money. Whatever's the most expensive. Yeah, magic stick. I think I've heard that one's good.
All right. Yeah. So grab all.
Middle is missing.
Top is missing.
Okay, so now I think my little donkey friend is coming.
Mm-hmm. They'd probably be on the map somewhere, right?
Yeah, you see the wings your down here? That's the donkey.
What's that donkey?
Missing bottom.
Oh shit, wait.
My
oh shit. Oop. I was controlling the donkey and not me.
Like, we're out here playing games on GeForce Now on an ultimate subscription because, you know what? We need to maximize what a 4090 can do by playing 2012's Dragon's Dogma and 20-whatever's Dota 2. But that's the nice part. There's, like, a whole spectrum of games. And, so, you know, you can find ways to play games that are older or you can, you know, games you've already played, play them nicer.
Compelled to battle.
Also 2012, the same. We got Dragon's Dogma and Dota 2 in the same year. Some people picked one path. They picked Dota. Some people picked another pack. And it was Dragon's Dogma. Just think long and hard about the kinds of people that picked those paths and how their lives turned out.
Yes.
Damn. That Dragon flame breath didn't do as much as I was hoping. I was hoping it was going to be like, here's some gold. And the answer was extremely no. All right, now I got to bring the donkey up.
So, you know, I see in the corner KDA. What is LHDN?
Hell yeah, there we go. I just bought something, and now I have it. I'm a Dota master. I made the donkey work. Oh, you want to know what KDA, huh?
No, I know what K... Well, I know what the A is. I don't know what the A is. Ally?
Assist.
Is this... Assist.
Overrated. Stats like that are overrated. The real value...
Go ahead.
Yeah, no, the real measure of a Dota player is just like... How often can they just sort of anonymously hang out in lane doing very little?
What is the equivalent of a triple double in Dota terms, KDA? Like what?
Well, I mean, you shouldn't. So the thing is, like, you kind of want to distribute Ks to certain characters and not others. So, like, kind of the measure of some of this is making sure that you're filling up, like, the right sort of stats. Like, your support characters should have lots of assists, right? Is kind of one thing, and not too many doubt. Like, probably the equivalent is, like, really leaning hard on whatever sort of stat your character is supposed to be building towards.
By the honor of the ancients.
Missing bottom. Are you winning?
Oh yeah, we're probably.
Attack.
Are we winning? How do I bring up the scoreboard real quick?
I mean, you have a lot of gold. Should you spend more of your gold?
I should spend more gold. Yes, but I need to afford a cabinet too, so. Alright, so. You don't want to mess too much with those towers because they hit hard. So you want to.
The dragon waits.
Oh man, it's like way too much tower damage there. That was kind of clumsy. Is that good? Yeah.
Well, Kato was pointing out you can see team kills up by the clock. I understand that. I just... What...
Oh, no.
Determines the dub? I'm trying to figure
out... Oh, we're going to tear down these towers. And then we're going to blow up their pool.
All right.
Uh-oh.
I love pools, though. Why can't we just all swim in the pool instead?
Yes.
Hey, that was a dragon. We got some constants between our games.
The phantom strikes.
It's all me, Patrick.
I never I didn't even have to ask. The work speaks for itself, Rob. Are you controlling that dragon as well?
Yeah, I am the dragon. I'm the dragon knight, baby. Oh yeah, what's good, Axe?
Can you find some poor villager and tear their heart out, and then let them be a little horny for their family member in the house and not realize it?
Okay, I need to get out of here a little bit. This got a little out of hand. I'm gonna go hang out by the tower, and we are gonna go shopping again.
Top is missing.
Let's see here. So we'll just buy that.
People saying boots. Did you get the boots?
Actually, I probably should have. Just not enough gold. Okay, so we will take all this out. Yeah. Top so I missing. Just got the boots. The dragon's gonna come
Who
deliver them.
Calls to Dragon Knight? these battles, gold wins wars.
So true, Dragon Knight.
No.
See, Dragon Knight's just like me. Like, he's a strategist. You know, starts off slow, but just unstoppable once he gets fed.
RylaGeo7 points out, Rob, I just want to... No pressure, all right? But do you want to know who's the number three Dota 2 streamer right now on Twitch?
Who?
Us.
Oh, we're not... You know what? We're not... Sorry, Phantom. I am not... I can't bail you out of that, bro.
Number three Dota 2 streamer on Twitch. Not even partner? Not even partner? What are we doing out here?
All right, now... There we go. Donkey, go home.
I'm always saying this.
And do I have to do things with it? Do I have to actively use these fucking things? How do I get more mana?
I mean, items that they have buttons attached to them, like hold Z, on. B.
Yeah. Okay. So now I consumed health to get mana. I'm gonna eat a tree. And now we're back up. Put the word out.
Hey, we need trees out here. Did you ever watch Banshees of Inisherin? Did you ever get around to that movie?
No, I didn't.
Ah, come on. This will only hurt my life. I love that movie. Dragon to the
fray. All right, so it looks like my team is pushing mid.
Yeah, tell me about it.
Compelled to battle.
Middle is missing.
Middle is missing? Yes. Does that mean your middle is missing? Their middle is missing? Malcolm in the middle is missing? Attack. That is the titular tower, right? That's...
Yes.
Break that tower.
Yes.
Who calls the Dragon Knight?
Who calls the Dragon Knight?
Yes.
Is missing.
Oh no, he's stunned. Rob.
In strength is victory. Onward. Yes.
He's eating trees. Why do they eat trees? What's the lore reason for the tree eating?
Does a body good?
Yes. Missing middle. Swiftly.
Look, Patrick, if this brings me closer to new kitchen cabinets, I will eat as many trees as it fucking takes.
Rob just out here eating bamboo. I mean, Rob, you might say it's all wood all the time.
This is how farmhouse style. I'm just such a devotee of farmhouse. I'm just out here now just like eating raw trees. So the point is, so Patrick, like we've almost got this tower down. So the thing about this is, oh shit, oh fuck you, Pudge. Fuck. Okay, so which one did they bring down? Was it this one or is top is down?
Mega kill. Double kill.
No, top looks
the
up.
Enemy's bottom top has fallen.
So the point is, okay, now they're once these towers fall, like they basically start losing map position. Those little like lines of creeps that like wander around. They will push as far forward as they can. Like before they get killed. if there were no heroes on the map, the game would just sort of stalemate because they would march up to each other and fight to the death, and any of the breakthrough would be killed by the tower. But things progress because teams push in and like bring down these towers. And so suddenly creeps push further in and you lose map control that way. Like, so right now I can be here pretty confidently because the lane is watched pretty far up. Now they have lost their bottom tower that was here. So they can't really see very well. If I start like breaking off and wandering around the river, start wandering around the the jungle.
Rob, you know more about Dota than I was expecting going into this experience.
I need no steam.
Can you explain yourself?
I mean, I covered esports a lot for a number of years, and like I can't play this game very well, but I do understand the principles of it.
Okay, all right. I guess that part makes sense.
And like, all my degenerate friends love the international, and so like once a year, it's a bit like the tour, right? It's like, I guess we're all watching the international this week. Let's fall back, dude. I can't look.
Uh-oh.
I can't save people from themselves.
Uh-oh.
And they've left me kind of out on a limb. Now, the question is the team going to pull?
Curry is wicked sick. I agree, game.
What's my gold situation? I got a lot of fucking gold.
Yeah, get out there. Spend that money.
Get some cabinets.
Steel wins battles. Gold wins wars. The dragon waits.
The dragon does wait. The dragon goes fucking shopping.
Who's Guri? Because Guri is just crushing it out here on the field. Constantly seeing Guri. What are you doing? Are you?
I
need no steed.
I was just enjoying a nice water feature.
I don't think that's gonna fit in your apartment, Rob. I feel like that is that's too big.
Your top tower is under attack.
Oh.
Triple Kill. I do love that Valve hired the Unreal Tournament voice guy to record all the lines for this. Is that true? I didn't know that. That's fantastic. I have a much deeper affinity for Unreal Tournament.
I wanted to buy this. Oh shit. Okay, I was trying to buy straight off this. Alright. Donkey, I wish you free. Invisibility. That's how that line goes, right?
My favorite line from Shrek 3.
Your middle tower is under attack.
So is this currently going bad for you because they're pushing this far close to your base? No? You're pushing them back? Pudgy's getting out of here?
Yeah.
Oh, he's stunned. Oh, you took out that tower. I guess I missed that.
Yeah, so he's... I don't think I'm going to get this kill. Yeah, so he just peaced out.
Oh.
Now, I did use my ult to do that, so like I'm not going to have access to that ability for a little bit, but now we can push up, and what's going on over here? Yeah, there we go. Dragon to the fray.
Dragon to the fray.
Oh, that's right. I meant to get donkeyed.
E-E-Ed to dead. If you press the arrow bottom left, the courier will bring the items to you.
Okay. Alright, so how do I sell this shit here?
Cyberspace cat. Rob, if you press Alt F4, you get your life back. No way! We gotta spin the wheel at least one more time before we get out of here.
Recipe magic wand, huh? Do I want that? Do I power treads? Get on him. And then
Fresh mate. Killing spree.
Press the arrow? People really want you to press the arrow.
Wait, press what arrow?
That arrow. I think.
On the career? Or
I think what you just did. Because aren't they just doing the thing on their own now? I'm trying to interpret
yeah,
for the cat in
sure.
a game. Oh, the one next to it. The other one. What's the double arrow do?
Your middle tower has fallen. Your top tower. Oh, using the like speed mode.
Dragon to the
Is that it? Like
yep.
he just started.
Yep. 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 Yep.
Oh wait. Hold on here. Hold on. Shit.
Oh, is that your base?
Yeah, dude. The squad is not doing great here.
Oh no. Oh, Pudgy's leaving.
Yes.
They all gone. Yeah, so I'll be honest, like I haven't really been tuned into what's going on in this game. So the team's kind of, the squad is in trouble. I'm not going to lie. And I think the real issue here is that, you know, I can't be everywhere at once.
No, I mean,
team,
if you could,
team too
you'd be
heavy.
Fine.
Team too heavy.
Ah, my shoulders. Ooh. It's just, oh. Carrying this team is just too much for me right now.
Ah, oh, shit.
Well, that seems bad.
I agree there. Yeah.
It does seem like they're making regular pushes into your base.
Yeah. No, this is not going.
I've played enough Warcraft 2 to know that you don't want that.
Okay, so it's time for. I don't have money. Hang on. Can this little guy sell shit? Slick career.
Your middle tower is under attack.
Yeah, so how do I sell this stuff?
Your middle tower has fallen. I think you should just spend a lot of time in here. Just hang back. Just chill. Can't sell while dead.
Well, now I'm alive.
Ready for capitalism.
Okay, so they... Oh, the Sorry, my. Well, no, I'm controlling the courier! I'm controlling the courier! I'm taking the courier to battle! Oh, fuck.
Can the couriers fight? Do they got any,
Yes.
Come on, donkey.
Compelled to battle.
That looks bad. That tower went down.
Oh, man, I just got nuked. Oh, man.
This doesn't look good. I gotta be honest, I'm not an expert. You know, I haven't played a whole lot of Dota, but I get the sense I'm gonna call in.
Yeah.
Bad?
No.
Bad?
It's pretty bad. It's pretty bad. And the issue is, you know, my character is really meant to be sort of a support role here.
Totally understandable.
Yeah, I'm not meant to be killing these guys.
It's very common in video games to play a dragon character that functions in the support role. And that's usually how they classify those warrior dragon types.
Your top tower is under attack. He can't get out. Oh shit. I hate this thing though. This sigil's bad news.
Your top tower is under attack.
Yes.
All right. So what's the team? What is the team doing? That's like, it's not. This is not a I'm blaming the team move. I just genuinely don't know what they're doing.
I think they're looking for inspiration and leadership, and haven't found it yet.
All right. We'll take this wave in. All right. They're all. We're pushing mid. All right, time to run it back.
Your bottom tower is under attack.
Yes. Compelled to battle. A shield.
Your bottom tower is under attack. Your bottom tower is under attack.
Dragon up.
Your bottom tower has fallen.
Did you need that bottom tower? Like,
it would have been nice. It would have been nice.
Okay. Yeah, I got you. That's
the
cool.
The mid push never materialized. If I'm being honest.
Rob, if you were to compare the events of this game to a battle in history, what would you like? What comes to mind?
This is kind of a like, let's say kind of a Carte Grasse type thing. Where the British army got rocked right before Waterloo, but they did go on to win Waterloo. You know, you never know how things are going to turn out.
I mean, unfortunately, we're just not going to have time to watch Rob play a second round of this. But if we did, I mean,
oh shit, fuck. So that was a decent turnaround.
You killed the person who was killing everyone.
Yeah, so like they pushed up a little far and all my stuff was up and they were by a tower, so like when things turned on them they turned fast and they didn't have any abilities really that were up to stop this. So now we're going to break this tower down real fast. And remember, like, so these death timers mean there's nobody on the map until these guys come back up. Like, all right, now they're starting to respawn.
But you're going to take out the tower before they do.
Yes.
All right, so the team, the push is breaking up. The team does not want this. Swiftly. But they're going over here. I'm trying to figure out what their play is.
Always good to be part of a team, having to interpret the plays.
Okay, they're defending bot. Okay. Oh wait, I see what they're doing.
Compelled to battle.
Oh, didn't even need to do that. So there was a guy down here, and I was like thinking if they were gonna start like falling back. It was good to be in lane behind them, but they did not make it out. So now we know we know they got some people top.
Your top tower is under attack.
I need those.
Your top tower has fallen.
Okay.
This is fine. This is fine.
Yes.
Rob, people are very concerned about the amount of money you have.
Oh yeah, yeah, I should.
As an FYI.
Yeah, yeah, no, it's true. They should. Oh fuck. Okay, we got a problem here. Yeah, we're.
So now they're taking out your heroes, so they can take advantage of the death timer.
Yeah, yeah, I just got pulled in by Putt. Yeah. that was bad.
This seems really, they're gonna do some damage here.
Right, but I just bought back in.
Oh, you spent your gold to get in fast.
Yep.
Okay.
And he got pulled immediately.
Yep. Yeah, nope, that's not, that did not look
and
good.
And now I can't buy back in.
Yeah, now that seems to be your main thing right there, right?
What the, yeah, no, this is the game. This is the game.
Oh, that meter is going down kind of fast. Now they're leaving. They put in their damage.
Our guys are, so our teams respawned. So they didn't want to keep pushing that. The thing is, they can't afford the Black King bar. So I just burned through a lot of gold that I really need for late game items, unfortunately.
And, oh, you died.
Yeah,
they won.
All right. So, Dota, great.
Let's spin that wheel one more time, Rob.
All right, baby.
See where it takes us. So, if you're joining us late, joining us now, we have taken all 1,600 plus games on GeForce Now. We have put it into a single wheel. If you've watched Remap before, you know that we love our windows, and we also love our wheels. And we are going to spin this wheel to see what is our last game of the day for this stream.
Yeah, that's dominance, my friends.
Woo, woo, woo. Are you sure? Oh, you were sure you wanted to quit.
Yes, that was dominance. We didn't need to examine any closer than that.
All right, Rob's going to take us over to the wheel.
Wheel time, baby.
Did you transition?
I did not.
Give us wheel. What will you give us, wheel? What are you going to drop on? I hope it's League of Legends. Is that even on Steam?
It's on Epic now. And it's supported through GeForce Now.
That's true. There we go. This could be anything. When we tested this out last night, Rob got a real banger.
Dungeon Defenders going rogue.
Do you own that, or do you need me to make you own that?
Hang on.
I have now added it to my account, so if you need to... I doubt you own this. I really doubt you own this. This game came out in 2022 and didn't have the most positive reviews. But now if you resync your Steam account, it should have access to it.
Hang on.
So Dungeon Defenders Going Rogue it combines roguelite action RPG and tower defense gameplay into a crazy free-for-all where it's you and up to three friends versus hordes of enemies. Select your hero, survive the waves of foes, unlock new weapons and runes, and take on the bosses that await you. Normally this would be the kind of game that I could join Rob to play, but as a result of the way that we have, I'm using...
Yeah.
The way that I'm giving Rob access to these games means that I can't do that.
Can't do that. No. Sorry. Oh shoot. Okay. Games. Where's the sync option again?
You go to the three lines in the upper left hand corner.
The hamburger.
Go to settings.
Yeah.
And then on the right hand side you're gonna have your accounts and just hit resync.
Yep, there we go. There we go.
Neurokip, is Street Fighter 6 on this? And if so, how much money do I need to spend to see Rob playing it?
The wheel's not up for bribery.
It does act, but, well, Rob, actually, it is. So I believe in the settings of the wheel, you can do weighted values. I don't know exactly how that works. I didn't go right now. Everything on the wheel is equally weighted, but I think there are ways of modifying it. Make sure you transition over to.
No, I know, but like, if this doesn't go through, we're gonna have to fuss with some stuff real quick.
I see.
All right, it looks like we are in. All right. All right.
Okay. Well, hey. Maybe you can play it anyway.
Play that game. Yeah, this kind of seems fine.
Yeah, I think we're good to go. What are talents? What are loadout? Who could say? Rob's about to find out.
Available points. Heavy-handed. That works. Added level of heavy-handed. All right, I'm ready.
Just make sure you find a dragon in this one. We want some thematic consistency in everything we're doing here. Well, look, we've got powers, potential lanes. I mean, you might be able to take everything you just learned.
Where are my guys? Nope, I think, Patrick, this may not be applicable to what we just learned.
All right, time to decide your powers.
Oh,
all right, little spinny.
Okay.
Well, I do remember seeing it may have been called a core. May have been called an ancient. But that was under attack.
Oh, wait, hold on. Hold on.
Oh, you love a good sentry gun.
Oh, yeah. Now, this is some fucking gaming.
So yeah, we're playing this GeForce Now where, like, part of what happens with GeForce Now is that when new games are added, you might already own them on Ubisoft's service, on Epic service, on Steam service, and then those games then become available to stream, whether it's on your computer, your phone, your iPad, which you can do through the browser, or there are discrete applications on various other devices, including TVs, or if the game is supported but you don't own it, then when you purchase it from one of those storefronts, then you can stream it to all sorts of different devices using GeForce Now. And so that's what we did. We basically added a new game to our a service that we didn't.
Yeah.
It was already supported on GeForce Now. We just, you know, used the magic of purchasing to add it on here.
I wonder, should we have been removing options from the wheel as they're like, so that like we couldn't, there's no chance that Dota could pop twice, for instance.
I can remove options from the wheel. That is something I can do. You sound there was a little bit of terror in your voice.
Oh no. I love Dota. I think you tell how happy I was to be playing Dota again. And trying to remember how all this works again, and like, it was just so much fun. And what's great is people, like Dota people, they love watching people learn, and they love to help people learn.
They do. It's I've heard nothing like words like toxic in that community.
No, thank you. You must be thinking of a different game. And like, what's the other great thing too is like, you know, you hear that, you know, you might think you know someone really, really well, but, you know, playing Dota, you get to know, like, the best version of them.
Yeah, that's so true. That is such a great point.
Where am I? There's more?
You're not like in the hub? I guess it's I mean, it's called Going Rogue, so it's probably like you're going.
Oh yeah.
As far as you can get, and then starting over. And it definitely seems like a game that is probably best enjoyed with friends. And you can do multiplayer, like
yeah.
You could sync up with your Steam friends, you know, in the same way that you could if you were launching the game natively on your computer.
Shouldn't I be able perhaps to buy new abilities? Maybe not.
Spells. Maybe it's only in between.
Oh, this guy can't climb stairs to save his life.
Rob, your core is under attack.
I know, it keeps happening. This is just a day for having your core be under attack.
Well, at least maybe we'll see if you can do an upgrade and do one more run before we bring this to a close.
All right, so now talents. I've got one more. Cool. Load out.
I don't think I've played any of the Dungeon Defenders games. I mean, I know people quite like them. It sounds like this is the most recent one. Dungeon Defenders is 2011. Dungeon Defenders 2 is 2017. Dungeon Defenders Awakened is 2020. And then Going Rogue is the most recent game from the studio. Shifty Disco, this stream has prompted me to finally do my core physical therapy exercises today. So thank you, GeForce. Thank you, GeForce, for reminding us that if you have lower back issues, if you have perhaps a herniated disc, like I do, you don't want to get those shots. You don't want to get that surgery. You just sit down, go into that cat pose, and go meow.
What's the cat pose?
You basically like, get down on all fours, okay. And then like push your stomach down, and then push your arch your back up.
Okay. And... Yeah. So what's the was it? Because for me, the lower back one was the. I don't know, it's almost like a sea lion pose, or you sort of sit with your like butt and your legs stretched out behind you, and then you sort of rear up on your wrist, so you're like pushed up, and that would like sort of pressure the disc back into place for me.
Yes, and I've had a herniated disc issue for like 3-ish years now, and just every once in a while it flares up, and I just do the exercises, and I haven't had to advance it past anything than just, but this most recent one, like I was being bad. Like I can tell when I like lean down that you should probably start doing your exercises before it becomes more than just a slight pull in your back, which is what it's always been. The first two cycles was a pull in my back, and it flared up the first time when my youngest was born, and I think I noticed it when I was setting her down in the crib. And I just did the exercises. It went away. No big deal. But this time I was doing some yard work. Leaned down for something where I just put, like, literally was not using my legs at
right.
all. It was like, I'm just going to use my entire back to pull this thing up. And I didn't feel something pop, but I dropped it. And it hurt. And it's never hurt before. But thankfully, 3 days later, I'm like super diligent about doing my exercises. Yeah. Like I do not F around with that stuff. And because like the physical therapy people, when I went in the second time, I was like, is this any different? And they were like, look, we have on your chart that you got discharged early from physical therapy because we could tell that you were doing your exercises at home. And they were like, the thing about physical therapy is it's really after the first couple of appointments, not actually about learning anything. It's that we don't trust that you're doing the exercises. And so we come in, shame you into doing a more intense version of them here at the office, and then hope that you do some of it at home. And they said, if you just do exactly what you did before, that thing's gonna go away. And so I just did that this time. And like, my big moment was standing up today after a podcast recording, and I didn't feel any discomfort, which was like, yeah, I did it. Followed the I followed the rules.
So I've been pretty lucky in that. Right, so that's equipped. That's equipped. I've been pretty lucky in that I used to have my back go out like clockwork, like once every year or so.
Yeah. For me, it seems to be 8 to 18 months of I don't actually do the exercises that if I just did them once a week, I would probably never deal with this problem again. And I'm going to try and be better about it this time. But it's like 18 months where like the disc is like,
yeah,
like, I'm but, back.
So it hasn't happened at all since we got Mina. Honestly, like I haven't even had the twinges where it's like it's starting to go, and it used to be really regular. And I think the big difference is just like honestly, take your dog for a walk. You spend a lot of time like bending down to pick up shit, all this stuff. There's a lot of like little motions you do that are kind of good to stretch things out.
It turns out, can you pet the dog on Twitter? Is both a delightful Twitter account encouraging game developers to let you pet the dogs, but also
the core, bro.
Petting your dog is good for your back. Yeah, I don't know where that core is down there.
Wow, this is really like a knife fight in a phone booth type situation here.
Yeah, we're going to have to talk to the architects that put together this area. I don't know that this was the right place for the core necessarily. Really seem like right next to the right next to those explosive barrels. Like, is that really where we think we want to put that? Uh-oh. You're under attack. The core's under attack.
Where are they spawning in from? Because it's like, I feel like I'm defending this thing pretty close. Like, what's this shit? Yeah, no, they're coming out of the corpses of the dudes I kill. This is bullshit.
Come on, turret, do your business.
How many fucking waves? Hang on, how much more of this shit do I have to do?
What's
this 11 out of 100? What's this
crap?
Yeah,
the number at the top does not seem to be going down. I gotta be honest. I'm not sure what it necessarily
foundries and forges.
Do you need to also be going out?
Yeah, hang on. There's these little check marks over here.
Uh-huh.
And
don't worry, Core, just chill. Core, you just chill for a little while. Yeah, I don't think this is what you need to do.
No, I
Core, how you doing? Can you check in? We're off here looking at these check boxes. We're not sure what they do.
And you clear the way?
Oh, I bet, Rob, I bet you had to actually clear the barrels so the core could keep moving.
It was like a pushcart level?
I think so.
Okay, Pat, I don't know that I like this game very much. If I'm being like real honest here.
Well, that's okay, Rob. Like, GeForce Now is game agnostic. It's just here to let you play the game.
Spin the wheel one more time?
Yeah. You know what? Sure. Why not? Let's give the people what they want. They love the wheel. And we can play a game for a couple more minutes.
I'm going to click remove on Dungeon Defenders going rogue.
Oh, look. You can't just do that. Come on, wheel. Do your thing. Let's also point out we did not remove Dota at this stage. So theoretically, the chances of a $1,600 wheel or 1,600 entry wheel dropping on Dota again, very low. But not impossible. Every once in a while, I unmute the stream so that I can just hear the music. I can't hear it right now. Genshin Impact would be a very good pick. I don't know that we could spare the time for Genshin Impact at the moment, but...
Earth Defense Force 4, The Shadow of New Despair.
Rob, is that already in your Steam library?
Nope.
All right, let me go ahead and add that. 4.1, it's right here. I'm going to go ahead and... All right, Rob, if you spin your own sync wheel, you'll be able to bring that game... And Demurge,
Demiurge.
Demiurge, is that our friend, Rob? Is that
yeah, a little, yeah. I mean, he's my friend.
Patrick, what are you gonna do when GeForce Now adds more games? Does the wheel grow? It does. The wheel can add new entries. Like,
wait, there's gotta be a maximum of the wheel. The wheel can't.
I don't know, dude. The maximum on most wheel services, of which there are a surprising amount of them on the internet, usually capped out at like 25 or 50. And so what was fast, and I sent Rob a different wheel that accepted 1600 entries, but it didn't look visually appealing like this. The wheel's aesthetics fell apart. It spun and it picked something, but it didn't have all of this glamour to it.
This is glamour.
I don't know what this caps out at, but if you've made it to 1600, I assume for the duration that we're doing these streams for the next month or so, that like whatever dozen games that get added, we'll be able to add. And also we're going to be removing games, right? So we play one, we remove it. I think we'll stay within the parameters of the wheel. So this will be our last one for the day. Checking out Earth Defense Force 4.1. I do think Dota has to stay on the wheel. I think we are going to keep it there. I think that one, for just humor purposes. Gotta make sure I get the right one on here. I don't want to... All right, I've successfully updated the game that we're playing. Rob, you really need to get an Xbox controller. I'm sure this has a mouse and keyboard support, but we are increasingly falling into territory of games that you really should have a gamepad for, probably.
Are you sure, though? Lots of people think you need, you need a gamepad to play this game. Is that true, though? How often is that really true? Isn't the mouse the most, nuanced of the controllers?
I suppose so.
Select the number of players.
It's just me.
Unfortunately, one. If a game lands on something that both of us own, we can play together.
I'm a ranger.
Choose a class.
Infantry force, ranger special forces, connected. Rangers are combat experts. The other classes are specialized.
Unlike Have you played any of these games, Rob? I have to assume no.
Assault trooper, member of a female-only special forces unit.
The Earth Defense Force games are great. I have not played one in a very, very long time. Probably whatever was the one that came out early-ish in the 360 era, like on around the time of like Gears of War. That's probably the last one that I played.
Oh wait, this is like forward air control. Like I could just be sitting there like calling in artillery. Oh, but it's best suited for co-op. Okay.
Heavy armored trooper. With the power frame,
Oh, but it says it's for advanced players. All right, we'll just do their basic guy. Just got to show love for G-Force here. Team Green all the way, baby. Oh, you think ambivalence is going to get me a new kitchen? I don't think so, my friend.
I didn't know.
People were asking about FreeSync. That's what during this segment, that's what I say to FreeSync.
I didn't know, Rob, I didn't see that in the contract where it said, show zeal, and, you know, like, you shoot up a rewards category as a result.
More money. All right.
Talk shit about the competitors, and you can go up the...
Yeah, all right, that's good. How do I start the mission?
Rob, I'm not sure if you have access to the stream layout, so you can just see, that, like, you appear to be superimposed over the soldier. If you could just move your head... a little bit.
That's way too much to ask of me right now, Patrick.
Okay.
I'm an entire bottle of Prosecco into this stream. Like, you should be grateful my shirt is still on.
Select a mission.
One bottle of Prosecco. But like a magnum, people, please. All right, emergency dispatch request. We have reports of giant insect sightings. Probably a prank after so many years. But better... So wait. Yeah, because this is Earth Defense Force 4. They've, like, fought big bugs before.
Oh, yeah.
Why would they be nonchalant about... Bugs? I would take these calls seriously.
Select a difficulty. The higher the difficulty, the better the item drops.
I feel like Rob has never been more alive than he has been in the last 2 hours of my life.
All right, using the radar. Well, all right.
This is a special news flash. We are broadcasting to you live from the scene.
Don't worry about that. Just hit the shoot bug button.
People are being attacked by giant insects. No.
Oh. Oh.
To have been exterminated 7 years ago, the insects actually survived.
This fucking rules.
Oh yeah, dude. It's like a. Hey. It's like a.
Gears of War. Get fucked.
A super competent action game wrapped up in B-movie trappings.
This rules.
Come with me.
Yes.
Let's go.
Yes, sir.
It's a mistake, right?
It has to be. The giant insects were supposed to be exterminated 7 years ago.
The giant insects
these,
were supposed to be...
These barks are great. This is fantastic. Oh, look at that guy. He's doing the movie guy thing.
Don't shoot him, Rob. Don't shoot him, Rob. Don't be the fascist.
Don't shoot who? The bugs?
No, you're looking at that person. They're just worried.
These bugs ain't shit. Hey, look, I'm just gonna run ahead and get these guys, okay? Yeah, I hear about Alien Menace here? How do I shoot other gun?
Rob has the attitude of John Goodman's character from
Mant?
No.
Matinee, sorry.
Now, what's the Spider movie? Arachnophobia. Oh, thanks, Giant Bomb.
Understood.
We should have told Giant Bomb hashtag ad, but you know, thanks all the same.
Oh yeah, hold on. Get some.
Look, sometimes an ad is just informing you of something you didn't know you would like. It's just an ambassador of information.
That's how I felt today. Yes, I have been an ambassador of information.
Rob, people are saying that you should press the arrow keys.
I haven't seen giant insects in 7 years. Why not?
The giant insects were all destroyed. Yeah! The last one was supposed to have been killed in Arizona. Some must have survived, hiding out for 7 years.
This is the kind of thing we live for. What is this? That is extremely intricate.
That was a lot of menu.
Rob, can you pull that menu up again? I understand there are these bugs here, but I'm gonna need to see that menu one more time. So, okay, go under shouts. Can you go under shouts again? So shout and then sing. Sing. No, 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 back. Sing. Here we go. Here we go. Can we give us one of these? What is going on here?
Oh, wait. These rhyme. These rhyme.
Wait, so this is a whole song?
Yeah, yeah.
Split up into little individual barks?
So imagine if we were all squatted up and someone sings.
Our soldiers are prepared for any alien threats.
And then you say.
Uh-huh. Chips and the aliens off the jets. Incredible. Wow. What a game.
It's, like, with a vaguely, like, off-brand Battle Hymn of the Republic song.
Infantry, stay close to the armor.
Ain't nobody getting past these babies.
You heard the man.
Oh, wow, wait, I gotta get over there. It looks like my comrades require help.
Can you run with shift or anything?
No.
7 years after the last nest was taken out. Where were these guys hiding all that time?
So, the extermination was a lie. They were lurking underground. So were we living above them the whole time?
I love you collecting all these big boxes.
I don't know what they do.
You want them, though. Oh! Yes! Look, you can be useful from far away. We're trying. I'm sorry. We got caught up in a little musical number. We're trying to keep morale and spirits high.
This is a pretty big city.
Yeah. Big city for the ants to colonize and live in. But, you know, all the same.
Yes, sir.
You did a good job.
Thank you.
Well, these jumping animations.
F yeah!
Again after 7 years, but soon they'll be an endangered species.
There's nothing to fear.
Hey, this wheel's great, man.
Yes, sir.
I love the wheel.
You're welcome. Some wheels treat you better than other wheels.
Oh yeah! Call me Robert Oppenheimer, because I have become death. I've become Shiva, Destroyer of Worlds.
Oh my god, this stream has been canceled. Rob, you know that they left the press event. The actors are on strike.
Yeah, but I'm an ally to the cinema, so.
Wait, Rob. Sing close to an NPC and they'll do the next verse.
No, they will not. Hey, bro.
Try it.
Bro. Wait, that was the closer. That was the wrong one.
Our forces have never been.
That might have been too late because we were at the end of the
game. It might have been too late. Rob, that game is fantastic. I'm delighted that the wheel is exposing you to all sorts of new things, like Dragon's Dogma, Earth Defense Force 4.1, The Shadow of New Despair, available on GeForce Now, which is what we've been playing all these games on today. GeForce Now, it's a cloud streaming platform that you can play on your computer, your laptop. You can have like a Chromebook, and you can be playing games off of 4090 using GeForce Now by just logging in and playing through a browser. There's apps on different devices. There's not native apps on iPhones and iPads, but you can go on the web browser. Different tiers. We're playing on Ultimate, which is $20 a month or $100 for 6 months. You can get 4K fast frame rates, and there's different tiers that go down from there. There's even free membership so that you can log in and buy and just try it out. And then the different tiers also influence how much time you can spend on the service playing. So like at Ultimate, you can play for like 8 hours in a row. So we get like a really long session in. But yeah, like every Thursday, GeForce Now adds new games. This week it was Dragon's Dogma Dark Arisen and Jagged Alliance 3, which believe me, it would have been very on brand for Rob to be playing Jagged Alliance 3 anyway, but it's not available quite yet. Maybe next week if the wheel allows. But that is going to do it for us. That's going to do it for this stream. Hopefully everyone has had a good time. We tried to make this approach to the stream something that fit.
All right.
Yes?
I will just say somebody asked a good question because I didn't really talk about this. Somebody did ask, what's the streaming latency and picture quality like? It is really good. Now, when we talked about this before, Patrick, I think we were pretty impressed by this years ago. Like, the service was pretty solid. Mm-hmm. And, I mean, like, a bunch of these games felt like I was playing them natively, which is really surprisingly. The color was a little weird in Dota, I will say. But like this game looks like I would not know this is not running natively. Now it has an aesthetic that probably lends itself to this, but I haven't felt like any sort of lagginess or like pixelation. Not every game compresses as well as others, but in all seriousness, this has been surprisingly solid.
Rob, NVIDIA in the chat says, hold Control N, and I guess you will show the latency if you do that in the GeForce Now. So that actually gives you a sense of what is going on here. If you want to see the data, you want some stats, we got them for you.
Okay, but I think next time we'll maybe ask our friends at NVIDIA how do we push this a little harder, because it does default a lot to 1080, but like we're on Ultimate, we're up here in 4K land.
That's true.
How hard can we?
I mean, push?
This game may not have 4K,
and the stream may not see that, right? Because it's piping back down to 1080 when it goes out. But we'll push it on our end, and it would make it sharper at the very least for folks watching. But we'll push. We'll be back here next week on Thursday as GeForce Now adds new games to their service. The wheel will return. Rob will return. I will return. But that's going to do it for this stream today. Thanks to everyone for watching. And we'll be back tomorrow with Exoprimal, which I'm looking forward to checking out with Ren, Rob, and myself. So until then, thanks for watching, and we'll see you then.
Bye, everybody.